the shadows and we doing what we please, yeah, yeah. We get better every day, take a second, check the wiki, so you better know the phrase, yeah. Yo, I'm still here, get my shovel, not the pit boy. About to pummel all the piss poor kids in the Discord. Distort all the views, twist them an inch towards my favor. Time saver, I'ma tell it all now in the case that I die later. Why wait, I might as well dilate on times well spent with these all whiny tight fucking online haters. Quasi fakers to the friend group, ditching out a moment's notice. Bitch, you isn't on my radar. Bonsai, jumping deep into the heap of shit. Hit the wiki, then I'm picking up particularly sticky situations. Like with Twixie when she flicking on a bean over voice chat. Scream on the scene in the meantime, the boys laugh. Tease but appease, like with peaches, avoid that. Wishing sauce, never would have voiced that. Now we in some trouble, then our whole group splits like pea soup. Big fight, wish I preview. Thinking Taylor should have said, Chris, I need you. But I doubt I would have been around. Why leave, Drew? Fuck it, I'ma move on from the subject and deduce a lot of buzz around the dudes that couldn't cut it. Do's and don'ts of what it was that you just couldn't fuck with. And I'm thinking of the one guy, dude, to be above it. And he losing all the fights like Alt did. Bye-bye, wasn't there to see the cataclysm of the zeitgeist. Happy that we never crossed paths in the timeline. If you ever see me take a flight like Devin in Japan. Fucking on a hoe we never met because he can't. Straight messing with the plan. Diz begins to stress and starts messaging the band. Confessing he was destined to invest in something grand. Like waifu figs that entice you, I be screaming out with that support like Taiju. Speaking of, I'm looking at Sakari like Haiju. Sorry that we carried out the beef like Typhoon. DoorDash, spare me all the D's. I don't care because I'm here to be declaring we're at peace. Unlike characters preparing to apparently succeed. I'm talking Kim who transferred out like a venereal disease. Whoop, barely on the streets. Now I'm cherry picking every single character I see. Fuck fairy tales, I'm talking about that WWT. Don't you make me spell it out because you all know what it means. As we hiding in the shadows by the letters on the keys, yeah, yeah. By the letters on the keys, and we hiding in the shadows and we doing what we please, yeah, yeah. We get better every day, take a second, check the wiki, so you better know the phrase, yeah. Yeah, yo, I'm still here, get my shovel, not the pit boy. About to pummel all the piss poor kids in the Discord. Distort all the views, twist them an inch towards my favor. Time saver, I'ma tell it all now in the case that I die later. Why wait, I might as well dilate on times well spent with these all whiny tight fucking online haters. Quasi fakers to the friend group, ditching out a moment's notice. Bitch, you isn't on my radar. Bonsai, jumping deep into the heap of shit. Hit the wiki, then I'm picking up particularly sticky situations. Like with Twixie when she flicking on a bean over voice chat. Scream on the scene in the meantime, the boys laugh. Tease but appease, like with peaches, avoid that. Wishing sauce, never would have voiced that. Now we in some trouble, then our whole group splits like pea soup. Big fight, wish I preview. Thinking Taylor should have said, Chris, I need you. But I doubt I would have been around. Why leave, Drew? Fuck it, I'ma move on from the subject and deduce a lot of buzz around the dudes that couldn't cut it. Do's and don'ts of what it was that you just couldn't fuck with. And I'm thinking of the one guy, dude, to be above it. And he losing all the fights like Alt did. Bye-bye, wasn't there to see the cataclysm of the zeitgeist. Happy that we never crossed paths in the timeline. If you ever see me take a flight like Devin in Japan. Fucking on a hoe we never met because he can't. Straight messing with the plan. Diz begins to stress and starts messaging the band. Confessing he was destined to invest in something grand. Like waifu figs that entice you, I be screaming out with that support like Taiju. Speaking of, I'm looking at Sakari like Haiju. Sorry that we carried out the beef like Typhoon. DoorDash, spare me all the D's. I don't care because I'm here to be declaring we're at peace. Unlike characters preparing to apparently succeed. I'm talking Kim who transferred out like a venereal disease. Whoop, barely on the streets, now I'm cherry.
Okay, did y'all like how I transferred, how I transitioned in the middle of the song there? That was very, extremely professional, just like it's very professional that Mez's avatar is taking up half the screen. Oops. Oh, and not only that, Mez, but they can't even hear you. Hold on. There we
What
go.
the hell?
I know, man. It was a reformat
You gotta
today.
stop. You gotta stop pocketing all them production funds, man. This is embezzlement. Probably get the prosecutor involved.
And you know what would be the best part too is if this doesn't even actually fix the issue I was having. That would be fun. So, welcome everybody to
Sounds
the
like
Beef
you need a
Stream
nap.
number 17. It's April 29th. It's almost May. You excited for May Mass? You gonna have a big May?
I mean, I finally have vacation in a month, so I'm 6 months working almost. I'm going fucking feral without a vacation. So
Yeah.
yeah.
Is this gonna look right?
Weather will be starting
No.
to change, you know? Start getting some really good PTN when it's not freezing.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We're actually starting to have really nice weather. Oh, here we go. Here we go from Jack.
What's Jack's problem
I
today?
don't. He's gonna bitch about something. Oh, I live in
There wasn't
California.
enough migrant cum in his chai latte or something.
Ooh. Okay. Spicy, but okay. Shout out that we now have second CatAv guy. We got Mez with us tonight if no one's noticed. Last vacation taken 2018. Yeah, well, how about this? Last vacation taken 2012. Okay? Huh? How about that? Huh? That's what I thought.
I don't
Shut
mean
the.
going away for a vacation. I'm just talking like time away from work.
Oh. Well, that's really rough then. That's really rough. Fucking rough. All right, well, let's hit it how we always hit it. Let's run a snack check real quick. Mez, you got anything tonight? Or well, you're out, so I mean you're not.
Nothing. I am coming up on 30 hours on a monk's fast, so I'm kind of
Very
hurting.
nice. I actually noticed just before the show I was a little behind on my calories for the day. And I like to get it like within like a couple of hundred to the schedule just to make sure everything's fine. Oh. Okay, now our chat's doing something weird. But yeah, I noticed that and I threw a couple of potato rounds in the air fryer, so yeah. I
I
love.
wasn't a snack, but I did have some fucking amazing French onion soup last night. The wife cooked it up. Oh,
Ooh.
used the drippings from a pot roast that we saved.
Ooh.
A little bit of port wine.
Ooh.
Oops, and I
Everything.
kind of accidentally moved into a separate jurisdiction. I'm no longer in town. Oops.
Oops. Oh well.
It's all right.
Just don't shoot anybody. Hard to. I'm not your boss,
Body,
you know.
going crazy. It's like out of bounds. I don't know if it showed up on the screen.
Wait, does it actually tell you if you're not in the right place?
We have a whole brand money who's a pop crazy. And each time if I adjust my firearm or if I take it out, clean it, and don't hit the fuck. It activates everybody's body cams in the department.
I
If I
got
drive.
like 40% of that, man. You're roboting pretty hard,
Right,
unfortunately.
hold on. About this? Is this better?
We'll see, we'll see,
I'm
we'll
going
see.
to. I am actually going to change my audio output.
Okay. Well, I mean it's probably 'cause you're on cell phone, but it's fine.
Well, basically, what I'm trying to say is yes, our department is very paused now. We drive out of GPS range. Or take our firearms out of our holsters, our body cams, and
Ugh.
ballistic.
Ugh, that's disgusting. That's
Yeah.
absolutely disgusting. Remember back in the good old days of policing when you could just chase someone down with your car and beat them to death with your nightstick?
Yeah, it's a shame that in 7 years I've become extremely jaded.
Yeah, that's a shame. You should just be able to pistol whip somebody that was giving you a little bit of lip, you know?
I used to be able to draw my firearm to actually unironically coerce people to do things. I can't now.
And the thing is, I don't even feel like, and you know, call me radical, but I don't even feel like that's that crazy of a thing. Like, just you're just kind of reminding them, you know? You're just kind of reminding them.
Oh yeah, it's so literally in the state of New Jersey, constructive authority.
Yeah. Whatever. Fucking
So
communist. All right. I think
you
I
know,
have
you get
everything
what you
set.
fucking deserve. People in the state are starting to realize that we can't do things like chase. There's only eight crimes that we chase people for. And crime has gone through the roof. I think motor vehicle thefts are up 124% in the state of New Jersey.
Jesus.
It's unreal.
You know where I hear they don't have much crime these days? Down in the down on Rocky Top. Just a thought.
Listen, it's a lot more involved. It's not like a regular job where
I know. It's fun to tease people with, and I will continue teasing everyone with it until my dream of...
If we could go...
Go ahead.
I have looked into leaving the state. It's just, I refuse to do... I'm not going to do another academy again. You know, you've got to... At least don't start me on base pay.
Do you have to do a new academy if you transfer to, like, a different town or state?
Different states, it depends.
Okay.
It's like, think of it like how concealed weapon permits are. Not every state honors every other state.
Mm. Okay.
Like, I could go to Florida. They're not going to honor my certification, but they'll put me through, like, an accelerated program for state guys.
Mm.
Texas refuses because, you know, Texas. Texas refuses to take any other state's law enforcement certification.
Right.
You know? So it's frustrating. The good thing is New Jersey has some of the, like, the most stringent requirements, though. So I can go to a lot of places. It's just they tend to be Democratic, left-leaning, soft on crime states.
Mm-hmm.
So why would I want to go there?
That's true. That's true. Well, that's a little bit of a shame, actually.
Well, that's one of the... that's one of the massive problems that policing is facing. You know,
right.
A lot of these states that pay well and have strong unions tend to be in left-leaning, Democratic, soft-on-crime states.
Yeah.
I mean, there's outliers. Like, Florida's really good, but issue with Florida is there's not really strong unions, and they tend to be more sheriff's-based, you know, where it's a political job.
And you would never work for a sheriff department.
I wouldn't have a problem with it. It's just... I would not work for a sheriff's department if I was serious about climbing an administrative ladder.
Okay.
Because then it gets highly political.
I understand. And things like that makes sense, actually. Okay. Okay. Well, I mean, yeah, that's now, since you put it that way. Oh, okay. No, don't do that. Yeah. When you put it that way, that makes a lot more sense. But, I mean, I don't expect everyone to, you know, uproot their lives. It's just a funny little meme to throw out there. Although, that being said, all of you should definitely move to Knoxville, Tennessee.
I mean, look, but why not turn your memes into dreams?
Yeah. Oh, look, there he is. Look, we now have the dueling cat abs. Look at that. Yeah. Oh, man.
Battle of the cat abs.
Yeah. Couldn't be me, though. I got a big dog guy. Big dog guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wolf.
Yeah, wolf.
Racist dog whistle. Mm-hmm. He likes dogs. Mm-hmm.
Neat says Coxville. No, I don't want to go live next to your mom, Neat. Got him. All right, we already did snack check, Prude, but hop in with what you got. I just heard you crinkling something.
Well, I mean, so there's a whole series of complications that led
here
to this
we
moment.
Fucking go.
However, I will say that I quickly ran and got this like a lemon kind of Gatorade knockoff that I had in the fridge.
Okay.
I have some smoked seasoned almonds, of course, and a little square of brownie.
I'm just so fucking Californian. I fucking hate you.
Hey, fuck you. I didn't have time for anything better. What would you eat? What would you eat at this moment? What would you be having?
Some delicious pizza, maybe a hot Sbarro slice, you know?
I do have pizza in the freezer. I could have.
My brother in Christ, if you need any snack, just crack an egg. That's you're done. There you go. Just crack an egg.
Just slurp it down.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
Yeah, it is.
I will say, though, I am probably going to break my fast in about 30, 40 minutes, and I'm thinking something greasy. I don't know what I want, but I want something
greasy. How's Sonic sound to you?
I mean,
Sonic greasy.
Sonic, I would have to go out of my way going home.
Oh.
Sonic also kind of sucks. So
you kind of suck. So
I feel like we agreed on this previously.
Death to those who insult Sonic. So
I'm not insulting Sonic. I just
I'm talking to Prude.
Drive out of the
I'm
way.
Talking to Prude.
I know. I'm just saying.
But yeah. It also kind of sucks. So
no, but you kind of suck. So why don't you lick my ballsack?
I think this is a great night to have Popeyes. I wish I had Popeyes right
Popeyes
now.
Popeyes isn't greasy though. Jeez. It's actually, you know.
Popeyes is kind of greasy. It's fried chicken, dude.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to pull some stuff up. But yeah. Okay. So yeah, everyone had to... Well, I was saying I had some potato rounds. You know, we were talking about that last week. It was pretty good. But how y'all feel about just hopping into it here, and let's just get into it. So first big news item of the night, and I'm not gonna try and pull up the rest of this shit. There we go. All right. Okay, cool. So now Mez is on here twice for some reason. Okay. Let's fix this issue real quick.
The cat abs are multiplying.
But yeah, so first off, Elon, remember last week when we were joking, it was like, haha, Elon might bite my Twitter, haha, teehee. Well, he just woke up one day and then was like, fuck it, here's $50 million, let me own this motherfucker. And now he, you know, kind of owns this motherfucker, not technically yet.
There's
a whole lot involved.
There's a weird amount of stuff involved with buying $50 billion.
No doubt they're gonna like try to find more stupid shit to like, not necessarily Twitter, but like outside parties, third parties.
They're trying to undercut it already. Like, it's already started.
I mean, they're trying to make him testify in front of Congress for some stupid reason.
I really want that to happen, though. I think the pure lols and memes that would come from that, because he's autistic. None of us are going to try and defend Elon against autism accusations.
I tell you what, though, if they try to drag Elon, a proud African American, in front of Congress,
that's true.
It shows the racial inequality.
Yeah. Yeah.
In this country.
Yeah, maybe that systematic racism thing is true.
It is. You know, I'm tired of the federal government keeping the African-American man down. He's a businessman. He's a single father because he's split from his wife or his baby mama.
Several baby mamas, by the way.
And he's trying to be a good man, run a business, be an entrepreneur, raise his children. And here comes the government trying to keep the African-American man down.
Many years worth of cases. Neat said, this is like the fourth time you've mentioned Sonic on the podcast. Well, actually, fun you mentioned that, because as of today, I'm proud to announce that we have secured a Sonic sponsorship. So this stream is sponsored by Sonic.
To find out more
about it. He means the hedgehog.
Google Sonic Inflation Beefy.
Right, that's the type of Sonic we're talking about.
Oh, that just gave me a terrible idea for some fan art I should get commissioned. Oh no. But yeah, anyway, so he's trying to buy this motherfucker. And man, he has kind of like been on one lately. Ever since he bought one, we're finding out a lot about like who Elon is, like, as you know, where he is like politically and mentally. And he's still very much trying to pull this like centrist thing. But you can definitely tell that he hates one side way more than he hates anyone else.
Well, that side pushes
many such cases.
Yeah, he's
like, there's a lot more to step on when it comes to that side.
Right. Yeah. I don't have all the tweets pulled up here, but yeah, he was talking some mad shit about he was saying it's like, oh, you know, I'm going to piss off the right wing and the left wing equally. However, the left wing just fucking hates everyone and they've made everything miserable and they hate themselves the most. I was like, damn, dude, spitting. And what I found interesting was Elon Musk is a South Park Republican. I don't know what that means, but I agree with it 100%. Yeah, so like, here's a good example. Elon Musk vehemently opposed Trump's Twitter ban. From what he said so far, he's opposed almost all bans. He said banning the New York Post for their coverage of Hunter Biden's laptop story during the election. That was atrocious. That should have never ever happened.
How they suppressed the story, yeah.
Yeah. And then six, seven months later, they went, okay, well, that was a true story. Okay, well, let's look into this now that it doesn't mean anything. So that was great. Thanks for that. But what I found really interesting was this. Co-founder Jack Dorsey was reportedly whispering in Elon Musk's ear that Twitter should be taken private. And Dorsey at one point came out and said, I think he had a little thread, and he was like, essentially saying, I'm very happy that Elon is taking over. I very much feel like me and Elon see eye to eye on all these things. And this has been said a lot in the community, talking about how Jack, despite being the Twitter guy, saying that Elon is the singular solution to leading Twitter.
Well, some might even call him a final solution.
You could. I wouldn't.
Twitter problem.
I wouldn't say that. But yeah, many people have said throughout the years that Jack Dorsey isn't like the left-wing radical that he's been painted as. He's some weird, like, old-school Silicon Valley libertarian type, whatever the hell that is or was.
Yeah, that sounds, yeah.
Well, that's it's a very dying breed, though, and I think he's the last of them. So
I think too, maybe some stuff that he might have been kind of implied as endorsing maybe towards the end of his time with Twitter. It could have been he lost sight of his own values, right? I feel like that's often.
And that might have been why he stepped down.
Yeah, he steps out. He's like, fuck this. I'm already rich. Then he looks back on it and he's like, maybe I fucked up at the end, right? Like,
yeah. And what's interesting, too, is that when the original takeover tried to happen, Jack voted against it. But now all of a sudden he's like, oh, hey, little you, Elon. Someone said, lots of people said it, Neat. Okay, sorry. Sorry, reverse, correct the record. Neat once said in Discord that Jack is an old school Silicon Valley libertarian. So there you go. Sorry, buddy. But this has led to some strange little happenings and little discourse on Twitter with Elon and a bunch of people. My favorite ones so far have been the, oh, you believe in free speech, Elon? Then why did you block me? It's like, that's not how that fucking works, you idiot. But my favorite one was actually from today. AOC, looking a little mommy, by the way, with the glasses. Oh, love to see it. Love to see it. She said, tired of having to collectively stress about what explosion of hate crimes is happening, which that's not happening, but okay. Because some billionaire with an ego problem unilaterally controls a massive communication platform and skews it because Tucker Carlson or Peter Thiel took him to dinner and made him feel special. If Peter Thiel or Tucker Carlson took me to dinner, I would do whatever they ask. I'm just throwing that out there. Right. I just throw that out there. If you take, like, and I'm saying, like, you take me to something like Dorsia, you know, I'm doing whatever you say. Doing whatever
Tucker
you say.
Carlson at the Golden Corral, what will he put on his plate?
Oh, my God. Tucker, if you're listening, take me to Golden Corral, my dude. I will do anything. That federal building, I got some fertilizer, my guy. For legal reasons, that is a joke. For legal reasons, that is a joke.
Well, he was referring to the landscaping outside the building.
Yeah, of course I was.
That's so thoughtful, and I'm sure you would hire, down on their luck, migrants. You believe in a path to citizenship.
Well, that, and I would definitely hire maybe troubled young men who had spent a lot of time in the Philippines studying under jihadists to help me with the fertilizer outside of that federal building.
De-radicalize them, of course. He's going to bring them down from that ledge.
Of course. But and then Elon responds, stop hitting me, I'm really shy, which is the cringiest thing he could have said, but it's hilarious.
That's
because
the best way to fight someone like
it
that.
Actually it's ended just up, it's just cringe. This, yeah, it just ended up as a massive ratio against her. And it's just, you love to see it. You really, really do. I mean, I obviously don't dislike AOC as a human being. As a politician, she's scum. But as a human being, you know, I'm just saying, she's kind of cute. And I'm tired of pretending like she's not. I've seen a couple of screenshots, I don't know if they're photoshopped, where she responded and said, oh, I was talking about Zuckerberg, and she deleted it. I don't know if that's true or if someone photoshopped that. But someone did joke and say, oh, it was true. She just had to delete it because she remembered her and Zuckerberg are on the same side. I mean, this whole story has just been crazy. I liked his tweet the other day where he says, next I'm going to buy Coca-Cola and put the cocaine back in it. Which,
Bird?
Based? So. Bird?
I mean, damn, bro. AJ Cobb's batting 2 for 2, though. But if I can light a fat blunt and then do a line of coke if we can legalize it?
As well as interactions from outside the company, this has like stirred the shit. I mean, we all remember, oh, okay, thanks for this. What the fuck? Install and run Google Widevine? Based? Yeah, I'm installing that. Fuck yeah. Because I don't think y'all remember the first time we talked about this a couple of weeks ago when it was like the hostile takeover thing, buyout or whatever was happening. And he was like, people were coming out of the woodwork and was going, wow, I work for Twitter and I'm the safety guy and I don't think it'd be safe if it. That's gotten even worse now that it looks like a sure thing that he's going to buy it. And it's brought up this interesting thing that Twitter's chief censor is making $17 million a year.
Yeah.
What? Holy.
Vijaya Gadde, I'm going to assume that's how you pronounce her last name, who earned $17 million last year as Twitter's top legal counsel, could be on the chopping.
Tech problem and are out of control.
Well, she's, yeah, and I'm guessing it's billable hours or something, because I guess she's a lawyer. But anyway, she was, yeah, so here it is. It's this little woman. Y'all may remember her as the one that went on
Joe Rogan Experience.
Yeah, thank you. On Joe Rogan. And Joe Rogan just tore her a third asshole, right? Just absolutely, like, putting her on the spot every single time she said something. And because she'd be, like, trying to explain something, and he'd be like, well, that's not true. And she would just kind of look at him like, what do I say now? Because in her experience, like, every time she said something, people just kind of nod their head and go, But she got in front of Joe Rogan, and he went, that sounds made up. And then she would just stare for a minute as the programming tried to catch up, and she went, what? Oh, it's Tim Pool.
She would have that,
okay.
She would have that look on her face, like when you're driving with your GPS and you make a wrong turn.
Yeah.
And it takes like a hot minute to like get back.
Recalculating. Yeah. Yeah. No, it was really funny. I just saw this Ghost of Kiev. So they've just gone all in on this, huh? So they're just going to make this whole thing the fucking. So they've never been able to prove that he actually did anything. So now, first off, I don't know if y'all are seeing this, but that picture looks photoshopped. First off, that looks like one of those AI generated people. Like, that looks like, you know, this person doesn't exist.com. That's what that looks like. And in saying that, I realize that's just kind of all Slavic people, not being racist. They just, you know, kind of have a look.
Well, and also this whole, like, this war hero doesn't exist yet. It's kind of also just the whole media coverage of this fucking conflict, too.
Yeah,
like,
that's not, like, it's all fucking this war hero bullshit. Doesn't exist. I fucking like, love that. I fucking
you know,
love
it's
that.
Like, it's just all made up bullshit fucking psyops. So, like, Westerners can feel good about billions of their fucking tax dollars being spent on bullshit.
Yeah. Tara Balka was credited with taking out as many as 40 Russian aircraft. Oh my God. Fuck. Until he himself was shot down March 13th while battling an overwhelming number of enemy force. Jesus Christ.
Piping it up like it's a microwave hallway from Metal Gear Solid 4.
Neat just said this guy looks like Zelensky. It's probably just fucking Zelensky photoshopped. That's so funny.
Every hero in this war has the same phenotype as fucking Zelensky.
he's
that great of a leader.
Then he said, oh, I'm racist against Slavs. Well, same.
I mean,
speaking of being racist against people. Oh, okay, cool. So Mez's average is going to be just all like 10 shades of fucked up tonight. So let me see if I can fix him again. I don't understand like why it's doing that. You know what? Sorry, Mez. You don't get
don't
an
strike me down.
You don't get an avatar tonight.
Fine.
You don't get
I'll,
an avatar. I'll fix it later. It's been a pain in the ass getting all this shit set back up. That's okay.
It's about to be the hardest thing in my life ever. Pump my own gas.
Do y'all remember in 2014? I think it was. In Washington, the state of Washington, they had like a thing for a long time where like you didn't have to pump your own gas or something. And I remember seeing it and they were like, they like got rid of that. I was like, now you can pump your own gas. And I was like, oh, okay, well, that sounds normal. Because I mean, I think like most other places in America, you pump your own gas, right?
I think besides, so it's New Jersey that does it on the East Coast, or is it?
I think, yeah.
Okay, New Jersey, and then Oregon, I think, has a law.
That might have been Oregon, yeah. And then, yeah, like the other 48 states do it the normal way. And I remember it was like my first experience with like the absolute disconnect between boomers and the rest of reality. Because like all the comments I thought were going to be like, oh, okay, well, that's great. And then all these people are like, I don't know how to pump my own gas. I never pump my own gas. How am I going to pump my own gas? I never pump my own gas. They're like, what the fuck? Like, this isn't brain surgery.
That sort of like learned helplessness shit.
Yeah.
I see that a lot in olds, right? But I also see it a lot in Zoomers now. And it's like, bro, the fucking internet exists. Just Google whatever you need. Like, just fucking type it in the search bar. You'll find 40 videos of Indian men explaining how to do it.
I don't understand how you need to Google it, though. It's pretty simple.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, it's self-explanatory. I'm just saying.
Station, you tell them, hey, put 20 on pump two.
Well, I mean, well, that's if you even pay with cash, but I mean, who pays with cash?
I mean, I guess if you like having letting the government track you, you know, via
That's my favorite thing, actually. That's my passion in life, is being tracked by the government.
Is it getting subpoenaed?
Right, yes. Yeah. In fact, I try to do it as often as possible.
Sorry. Same, actually. Big same. Actually, hey, thanks for that segue. I could not have asked for a better one. Speaking of, hey guys, you know what would be a really, really good addition to our government? So right now we're like on the verge of possibly a food crisis. Fuel's through the roof, inflation's going everywhere. So what organization, what board do we need more than anything right now in this country? That's right. That's right. We need a Ministry of Truth, which, great news.
Just like Harry Potter.
And just like Harry Potter. I got to actually find the fucking Nina Jankowicz.
Quite the pedophile extermination board I was hoping for, but I guess.
In Minecraft, of course.
Right.
I'm actually having trouble finding actual, like, whatever. I'll just pull this one up. Fuck it. I don't give enough.
I will be right back.
I don't give a shit enough about this bitch to actually do it right. So Biden, in just like a day after Elon threatened to buy Twitter in the most absolutely transparent move ever, said, he didn't decide to do it, but you know what I mean, decided, we should have a disinformation board to decide what you can and can't say. No, you know, like, you know, that whole First Amendment thing, fuck that, that's stupid as hell. But yeah, so we're going to have a disinformation board now, and it's run by this bitch who I was trying to run through Jack Posobiec's feed here, because he's been posting this crazy ass shit. Well, here's one from Darren J. Betty. This is good. Yeah, so Nina Jankowicz, I don't know, something Polish, who gives a shit? This bitch is insane. So she was first off, you can just tell, I mean, look at this phenotype. First off, she's not terrible looking. She's not. However, she just has these soulless fucking eyes.
She has a somewhat masculine lower third as well.
Yeah. Huge anti-Trumper. But what I'm looking for is I'm looking for the video where they found... What the fuck? Well, that's terrifying. Oh, Brandy Zadrons. I don't remember who she was, but I remember I don't like her. I'm trying to find the videos where, like, she used to... Ah, here we go. So she used to be in a band called a wizard rock band. And it was based on Harry Potter. And it was named after Ugly Myrtle, which I'm pretty sure was the bitch who died in the bathroom in, like, the first or second movie or book, whatever. And I forgot who said it, but they've changed it from, like, new, you know, global American empire or whatever to, like, theater kid government. That's who runs our government. Like, I've seen it said before, and I've said it myself because I've seen it. Like, people who are in our government right now are one of two people. They either saw West Wing when they were, like, young and impressionable, right, and, like, never moved on from that. Or they were theater kids, or some mix of the two. And that's literally everything that runs our government now, is either people whose only, like, knowledge of the government and how it should work is via West Wing, or people who were just bullied because they were in theater. And that's great. That's,
well, that, you know, that
amazing.
Just really makes me want to trust the experts.
It really makes me want to trust the experts. Yeah, I think about that and I go, man, sure. It really would be great if I could just, you know, trust the experts.
Right.
Fucking. Actually, it's bothering me now that Mez's avatar isn't on here, so I'm going to have to fix it. Because I'm that fucking autistic. Hey, boys. Do you, y'all like having autism? Because I sure do.
It's all right.
I wish I had the good autism, though, you know? Like, I wish I had, like, a good autism that...
like the Elon Musk autism, where you just,
yeah,
like...
Well... Yeah, I wish I had, like, Elon Musk autism that, like, let me build rockets and be a billionaire.
Right.
Instead, I have to make sure my stream that is live to 11 people, looks perfect. Which, by the way, 11 is a high number for us, so I'm fine. But yeah, no, I mean, I'm just so excited about having a Ministry of Truth, boys. I'm just so excited. I don't know about y'all. I don't know if y'all are excited, but I'm excited. I can't wait to see what gross abuses of power that they come up with and are never once held to any sort of level of accountability. So, can't wait. What about you? What about you, excited, Prim? You excited?
Yeah, you excited? I'm doing the soy face because it's going to be just like the Ministry of Magic.
Oh from my Harry god! Potter. Yeah, actually, cringily enough. Disturbingly enough, a lot of people were going, oh my god, she's just like Dolores Umbridge. Shut the fuck up. Even like if you're being sarcastic, just shut. Don't be like them. Please just don't be like them. I don't really have much more to say about that. I don't really care. Ministry of Truth dropping, boys. That's great. And fuck politics. We're done with politics.
Right.
Which is good because I have a lot to say. I have a lot to say. So as we've been doing the past few weeks, at the end of March and the beginning of April, we did a whole review on looking at what anime was coming up, and we said, this looks good, this looks good, this looks good. And I believe this was one of my dark horses, was it not?
Yeah, I believe you mentioned as much.
Summertime Render, or Rendering. It's could go either way. Oh, it's 25 episodes? Oh, Anja? Oh, Anja?
That's crazy, because also, so is Spy X Family, so there's a couple of ones this season.
Really? Spy X? Okay, that's great.
Yeah, apparently that's why they've included some, like, subtle filler stuff.
It was
they have to make a whole season out of it, and apparently that would really be kind of tight on the existing source material or whatever.
I just want to say, this show was a ride. Now, I'm going to read the synopsis real quick, and I'm going to see if it makes any sense after what I saw. All right. Synopsis. After his parents died, Shinpei Ajiro lived with the Kafune sisters, Mio and Ushio. But he has since moved to live on his own in Tokyo. But after Ushio drowns while trying to save the young Shiori, not going to try and say that name, he returns home to mourn her departure. Saying mourn her departure is a strange way, but I'm going to assume it's machine translating. However, bruises around Ushio's neck bring her cause of death into question. Taking a step back, Shinpei becomes convinced there must be another explanation. Dangerous entities roam around the islanders, and a vision of deceased Ushio asks him to save Mio as her final request. Mm-hmm. He is certain that something is afoot, and Ushio's death is only a piece of the puzzle. With the help of Mio and various others, Shinpei struggles to forge a future in which he, his friends, and family can stay alive. But the more he investigates, the more impossible such a future seems. This darkness infiltrates his home island. Just how much more suffering will he go through before finding the right path to save it all? Now, when they say that about the vision, so when I first played this, I thought something was wrong with my projector, right? Because it had like this whole, like, there was this glitchy effect to it, and I was like, oh, that's strange. But then he like snapped out of a dream. It's very strange. I was like, usually, like, when someone has a dream, it doesn't show up as, like, static, right? So that was, yeah, that was number one, and they did a very anime trope. It's like, he woke up, and he was, like, his face was buried in this woman's breast or something that was sitting in front of him. It was like, right then, I was kind of like, ugh, that's kind of anime. I don't like that. It was this woman, by the way, who was apparently,
well, you know,
a big character. But, yeah, and I was like, okay. So I kind of let it roll, and I kind of let it roll. And then I got further into it, and I was like, okay, first off, the editing of it is a little, there's a lot of jump cuts in it. And I really appreciate that in almost any me. I like jump cuts. It's slightly disjointed, and I even want to say there's like a slight bit of like David Lynchian dialogue to it, where like,
They're going for that kind of editing. I feel like they're kind of trying to create that sort of like discombobulating kind
Well, it's one of the genres is suspense, and it's very suspenseful. Right. And while we're talking about this, I'll pull up a trailer of it. And it's a little disjointed, and like they'll have like dialogue, and then that dialogue just like suddenly ends, and they're off to another scene, and then there will be like a jump cut to another scene that's completely unrelated. So one specifically I was thinking of was
Hold on, I see Watson's doing a stock video watch along.
It was kind of cute. I watched a little bit of it. It was cute. Yeah, we got his official trailer. So they did this one jump cut, and he was inside talking to his the dark skinned girl who you see here in a minute. Who, by the way, real big battle for best girl in this show. Ushio, right. This one, the blonde, is obviously very cute. However, the other one, the dark skinned one, who I don't know if she's actually dark skinned. I think she's just tan. She's a little tomboyish, so you just already know, my dude.
Right.
So she was standing outside the house, and it was like, was this earlier? Was this later? Like, what happened? And then the next cut was the next day or something, and it was very strange. I'm actually going to pause it right there.
Yeah, that was a little interesting.
I'm going to pause it right here. Because you started getting this sense, because they dropped in dialogue a couple other times. It was like, wait, because the very next scene was them in the cafe that their adopted dad owns, who is an absolute fucking unit. I'm trying to find him in this clip.
Right.
He's an absolute unit. And someone in the cafe says, hey, Shinpei, weird conversation this morning. You know, what the fuck were you talking about? And Shinpei just goes, ha ha, you need to stop drinking. I didn't see you this morning, and just moves on. It's like, wait, what? And then it's just some other strange things happen. Then they get to like this brief little exposition dump where they talk about there's a legend on the island to where there's a dark monster that can, like a doppelganger. And if you see your doppelganger, you die.
Man, you know what other show had a dark island monster?
Well, not quite like that, but
this reminded me of Lost a little bit.
And you'll notice here, there's this little rewindy bit. I'll get to that in a second.
I heard reference to dark monsters, and I'm back.
Oh, nice. Yeah. By the way, this blonde girl is off the charts cute. I'm just gonna say. This show is great. Yeah. I came back to the beginning. So the last scene of this, first off, it's like on an island. It's you know, very, very Japanese. And after they learn about the monster, like for some reason, they decide to go run through the woods. Well, they heard something. Oh, no, sorry. They went up to a shrine to ask like the holy man or the Shinto guy is like, can you help with this? And he wasn't there. Then when they were there, they thought they saw the dead girl in the woods. They chased after her. And they came to they were like, oh, we can't go in there. That's like the old abandoned World War II fort. We can't go in there. It's dangerous. So they go out because they hear a gunshot, which is not that strange because there's one of the main characters, this guy back here. He's like a hunter. That's his thing. In fact, he has a gun in this picture. So they track it down, except it wasn't him. It was this woman, the woman whose tits he buried his face in accidentally earlier. Right. She's been shot by someone.
Oh, no.
I don't know why she's out in the middle of the woods shot, and she pulls Shinpei close in, and she's going to tell him something. And someone just blows her fucking brains out.
Understandable. I hate it when that happens.
And it's like, whoa, what the fuck? And that's what this clip was from a couple of seconds ago.
Yeah. The gun.
Let me see if I can find it. Yeah, with the gun. The person that shot her was Mio, but this is Mio, but that's also Mio.
Right, so the whole doppelganger situation.
Mio fucking shoots real Mio before shooting the main fucking character, killing all three of them.
Based?
And I just went, what the fuck? You just murdered all three of like the big characters in the first episode? And it was just like everything went black for a second, and then it fucking Groundhog Day'd us.
So it's almost like a ReZero situation.
It is. It's like a ReZero Groundhog situation where like every time he dies, he wakes up just before he comes to the island. And that's what he was saying. He says, I'm back here on the morning of the 22nd. So,
is this original or is this based on like a game or a VN or whatever?
This is based on a manga that I have never heard of. It's apparently from 2017. And weirdly enough, the manga is not as highly rated as the anime, which is a little strange.
Right.
But I mean, it's finished, by the way. It finished last February, so that's good. I'm guessing.
How many chapters? Chapters 139.
139.
But I wonder if they could adapt the whole thing somehow.
I don't know. I'm not confident. However, this feels like something that's definitely going to get a season two.
Yeah, especially if it's that kind of show, because if they pull it off, that's the type of thing that people will pick up as word of mouth gets going. So this is actually one that after we found out that like Tomodachi Game wasn't going to be great, this is the one that I was considering picking up. So I might watch it soon.
Yeah. If you're juggling between this and Tomodachi, yeet Tomodachi straight into the trash and watch this.
I'm not going to watch Tomodachi.
Rocks. This is because
right now I'm only watching Spy X Family. So I was like, I could do one more
between Spy X Family and this season is bonkers. And I'm really actually kind
of good things about Spy X Family. There's, I really want to give that a shot.
You really need to. It's so good. It's honestly one of the best comedy animes.
Yeah, definitely recommend that.
And it's
one.
Not even like strictly a comedy. It's a little bit more action. And now,
isn't it Shinzo Abe approved their family and they have a child?
Yeah.
It's definitely baiting like Japanese men into finding families.
I mean, it's working on me. Now, here's something interesting we talked about during the preview back earlier in the month was that this company's only work has been Komi-san and all the Pokemon movies. Like, that's it. Oh, and apparently a Berserk. Oh, the
is that the
97 anime?
The 90s. Okay,
well, the 97 one was pretty good.
Yeah, that's classic. That's
highly rated. It's highly rated. Yeah. So okay,
it's,
so they're
as long as it's not 2016. That's fine.
They're actually a pretty highly rated studio that's just very quiet, because I mean it's like you don't. I'm looking at a bunch of these and I've never heard any, but I'm not like they haven't just created any turds from what I can say. Well, this was, but I think this was based on a game.
Right. Well, yeah. Game yes. Animes,
game animes are always turds. It's just a cash in.
Now, but I will say that the Rage of Bahamut series was decent.
Oh, they did Gunsmith Cats.
Yeah.
That's a classic anime. Huh. Okay. Yeah. No, I mean, this, I just can't, I cannot stress like, anyone watching, if you can only stomach two animes this season, make it Spy X Family and Summertime Rendering. Summertime Rendering is so good. Now, will it fall off? I don't know. All I know is that if the test of an anime is how good the first episode is, this season so far, Summertime Rendering has passed with flying colors, and this turd right here, Shield Hero season 2, failed.
See, you can't do the one episode thing. I think a good rule for any show, whether it's live action, Eastern or Western animated, you got to give like three episodes.
Yeah.
Three episodes.
But what I'm hearing about Shield Hero is that it don't get much better.
Nobody
cares about light novel shit. It's
if it gets mid season and there's like climaxes and shit.
Season one of Shield Hero was huge.
Yeah, it was a decency. I mean, I wasn't as fond of it as some people were, but it was still good enough to watch. And notably, it has a really good composer.
It's one of those shows like Twin Peaks where I feel like they dumped the premise way too early. Right. So the problem with Twin Peaks is they revealed who killed Laura Palmer too quickly. And I think the problem with Shield Hero is that they like gave him the glow up too quickly.
Mm.
Which, I mean, that's not the anime's fault. That's the director's fault, but or the guy who wrote it. That,
right.
But yeah, no, I mean, this, I cannot get over how good this is. I really can't. So, two animes, Spy X Family, the other one that I just said.
Yeah, so I'll pick up Summer Rendering, whatever. Mm-hmm. And then I might watch Shield Hero Season 2 if it turns out like, once it gets going towards action or whatever, like that matters.
Shield Hero 2 sounds like one where I'm just going to kind of wait till the end of the season and then see what people are saying. And if it turns out okay in the long run, I'll watch it.
Well, and taking it episode by episode, like naturally as it releases, is a lot easier if episodes are good. If they suck, it's a lot nicer to just binge it because you get through the shitty parts and you're not sitting there like, oh man, that fucking sucks having to keep up with this. It's very demotivational in a sense of like, oh, I have to remember to watch this week after week to keep up on it, but each week it fucking sucks. Like,
absolutely. Anyway, that's enough nerd shit. Let's talk about food.
Okay.
So tonight,
speaking of food, it's time to break my fast.
Oh yeah, all right. So what'd you land on?
I'm picking Wendy's. I just pulled in at a Wendy's. I'm getting
that's good. That's
now
good.
Now that's a good greasy burg. That's a good greasy burg. Speaking of greasy burgs, you know who I bet has some banger greasy burgs? Maryville, Tennessee. So tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we are introducing a new segment to the beef stream. Tentatively titled, what did I call it? Something about, I don't remember.
Is it written in the chat? Let me see.
Yeah, it's in discussion planning.
On the Culture Flux segment here, we have Google Maps Food.
I put Google Map Food Adventure, Maryville, Tennessee, better name pending. Okay. Neat shouting out a Baconator in chat. By the way, this stream is sponsored by Wendy's. Eat fresh. That's not Wendy's thing.
Is it?
Well,
no, that's Subway.
is Wendy's? Proud to announce tonight's stream is sponsored by Subway. Eat fresh.
I'd rather be sponsored by Wendy's.
I'll take either, to be quite honest. I'm not picking. But yeah, so in this new segment, what we're going to do is we did a little bit of this last week, just kind of impromptu, but Prude said it was fun. I thought it was fun. Everyone thinks it's fun.
Just by the way, apparently the company's slogan introduced in 2010 was, "You know when it's real." I've never heard that one in my life, but that's what...
For Wendy's?
Yeah, apparently that's the slogan they introduced in 2010, and I've never heard that.
I've never heard that.
Only Wendy's thing that I really remember is the whole "Where's the beef?" thing.
Where's the beef? But yeah, anyway, in this one, every segment, we're not going to do it every week, but every time we do it, we're going to choose a new town, go through, see if there's any good places to eat, look at the pictures, look at the reviews, talk about it. We're obviously going to start in Maryville, obviously, because it's the promised land, and we're, you know, kind of... That's kind of our thing lately.
It's a place of convergence.
If one will, yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll start here. So from this level of zoomed in, I'm seeing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different places. Well, actually, this is on the other side of the mountains. We won't go over there. This line right here, this demarcates the mountains.
Right. I feel like it has to be something like... I feel like it has to be you kind of... choose the center of whatever locale is being considered, and you do a certain radius.
Say like just this general area, like not too far outside the city limits.
I would say that's about a 10 mile radius.
Yeah, why not? By the way, the barn, like, oh shit, okay. The barn is part of Blackberry Farm, so it's like very snooty. So you don't just go there.
Sure.
Yeah. So the ones
when you
I can
say
see,
snooty, is it like country club levels of you
being invited? Dude. Country Club is essentially a Waffle House compared to this place. I talked about Blackberry Farm on one of my streams back in January, and like some of the places that you can rent at Blackberry Farm are $15,000 a night.
Good Lord.
Yeah, I was not prepared for that number, but yeah. Anyway, so from this level of zoom, I'm seeing 1, 2, 3, 4 different places. One of them is Waffle House. We're not going to talk about Waffle House. Everybody knows Waffle House is good. So let's just dive in at Las Margaritas Mexican Grill.
I'm bound to have some opinions on this.
All right. So let's see what we got here first off. Oh yeah, that was weird. So for some reason I have to click the arrows at the bottom because clicking on the pictures themselves doesn't work.
So that looks like kind of just like a salad offering they have.
Yeah, what is that? It looks like
a big thing. You got to pull the menu up too, because I mean those photos could be staged.
Well, sure. Let's start with the first impressions.
We'll do first impressions of photos. Then we'll go into the menu. We'll check the website. We'll check reviews. That sounds.
This salad seems to have both chicken and shrimp on it.
Yeah, and then ranch. Yeah, ranch, onions, right. Tomatoes, avocado.
This is actually not particularly Mexican, honestly, as far as salads go. These are kind of things that I could just put on almost any salad.
Is this like arugula or?
Looks like spinach to me.
Spinach, yeah. Sorry, that's what it meant. Okay, yeah. Whatever.
It's like a fajita thing?
Yeah, but what is this?
That's like a nopale. Like, that's the leaves of like a cactus or whatever. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, are those like good?
They're good. If you for some reason have to eat vegetarian at a Mexican restaurant, they're kind of meaty as far as vegetarian options go.
Meat saying these tomatoes look kind of shitty. I mean, they look alright.
Well, let's be honest, tomatoes are shitty unless it's peak tomato season. Like, there's a couple months per year where tomatoes are really good, and otherwise you might as well cook them down because the fresh ones are going to
suck.
This
chicken looks nicely seasoned, though. I'll give them that. That looks like a good seasoning.
That looks like a decent kind of thing. I think the presentation's a little strange. They almost put in like a mocajete or something, you know, like the
I think that's just like a draw or something, you know?
Maybe. Yeah. I'm just saying, if they brought it out that way instead of in a skillet, I'd be a little bothered. But
oh, okay. Let's see what's very classic. Of course, we have to have the white queso, the salsa, Okay, yeah, that's bog standard. Yeah,
what's the third sauce
chips
there?
Chips can be really good. Oh, that's a sad plate. That one you just back and forward.
I will. But wait, I don't know what that sauce is.
It's almost like a cream salsa or something.
I don't know. But yeah, no, that, yeah. He's absolutely, like, these could be cold. Like, first off, these almost look like they're from the store. These almost look like Kroger brand. So I'm hesitant on these. But to go back, yeah, that's a lot more what I expected from a hillbilly Tex-Mex place.
Right. Yeah, that's not particularly
looks
enticing.
Like bagged shredded salad. That's sad.
Yeah, in fact, you can even see a little bit of brown around here, so.
Right.
Again.
And the amount of liquid kind of coming off of them, too, is a little strange. Like, it looks like it would just be too watery in its constitution.
Right. And the tomatoes, again, super sad.
Right.
So, I'd still eat it, though. Yeah.
Well, sure. As long as it's not going to give me, like, food poisoning, I'll eat fucking anything.
Oh,
really,
okay.
These look solid.
Now, yeah, okay. I'm not so much on the cilantro
that
and stuff,
good.
But, you know, whatever.
I'm curious. I don't think there's any labels of what meat that's supposed to be. It looks like adobada to me, though, like seasoned pork.
I think that actually is what it is. Is that pineapples?
Oh, that might be al pastor if they're putting pineapple on it. The distinction here.
Al pastor, fucking legit.
So adobada is like seasoned pork cooked on a flat top or like a plancha. But if you do it spit roast, kind of like Lebanese, like if you're doing like shawarma or something, like that kind of spit roast thing. It's basically a cultural import from the Lebanese immigrants to Mexico, where they started spit roasting pork and then serving it with like pineapple and shit. And so, I mean, that looks pretty decent as far as al pastor goes.
I was hoping it would let me pull up this woman's avatar. Okay, so we're also gonna shit on the people who do the reviews too. Shout out to this woman having extremely painted on eyebrows. By the way, so
she's not horrible looking at all.
No, but she's got the paint, like they're literally like sharpied on.
Well, sure, but she's probably her name.
That's such a Latina thing. That's such a Latina
thing. Tania Lopez. She's Latina. She's got paint on her
Tania
eyebrows.
Lopez.
Also, Nissan Kelly. Well, fuck you. Okay, look, it's a
Here
fucking
we go.
Taco.
Here we
it's
go.
A fucking taco.
Here
That's what it's supposed to look like.
Here we go.
My only reservation here is I see cilantro, but I don't see onions. Where's the fucking onions at?
This kind of looks like onions a little bit.
It looks like it might just be the pineapple bits.
That's
but...
true.
Well, those are onions in the fucking ramekin. It looked like sour cream, but if you look, they're discrete little pieces. Those are fucking onions in that.
Oh,
central...
yeah. You're right. Absolutely right. That's the sour cream back there, I think. No, that's more onions.
I wouldn't ever put sour cream on this type of taco.
Okay, well, this is obviously fucking you up, so... Oh, God.
Well, it's, you know, look, we're
I mean, this looks
opinions.
Fine, but this is the most, like... Oh, okay, and they actually... Oh... Praise Jesus, they actually label this one burrito fritos, one ground beef and one shredded chicken.
So I think in that case what they're calling it's supposed to be fried burritos, which is what we would here call a chimichanga, right? Like
sure,
which is quite good. That's if you're going to this type of sit down Mexican place
from
that's
Gina Crawford. Oh God. Ooh boy. Ooh boy.
Well, yeah. She looks like an individual who would go to this restaurant or a burrito.
She looks like the kind of individual who would go here and think this is high quality Mexican food.
the most authentic.
Which I don't want to get snobby about Mexican food because that would be stupid. But yeah,
that's kind of my bit. But
I don't want to step on any toes here.
You can tell if a Mexican place is good if the menu's in Spanish first. Grandma's behind the counter cooking.
Yeah.
There's kids sat somewhere in the restaurant doing homework.
Yeah.
Like, the kids doing homework is the big thing.
Yeah, yeah. I've That's noticed. The big tell. Like, That's the big tell.
Yeah.
But now, granted, this kind of restaurant can be good. It's never going to be the same as maybe the type of stuff that I would consider the peak, but it's going to be, it can be good. Like,
I mean,
I've enjoyed
it's,
this, type
this
of
is edible. First off, interesting coloring on the rice here. I usually see rice in these places being a paler color. So this is kind of telling me their rice might be actually a little bit more seasoned than a lot of places are, which I'm all for.
Right.
Also, shout out to this person's name is Sandy Rapey. I'm not kidding. This woman's name is Sandy Rapey.
It's the same. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but it's like that. It's like that that poopy Rapey meme, but like sand and so shit. But I don't know if that rings a bell if you've ever seen that meme.
No, I think you just made that up. So, all right, let's look what we got here. We got the chips. We got the dip. They're eating al fresco. It looks like it's a boomer, possibly a war guy with the arm tattoo or a military guy with the arm tattoos. He's got some sort of, you know.
Specifico. I can tell by the label.
Okay. And she has like some sort of like margarita thing with very boomer vibes. But let's look at the plate here. What do we got here?
Well, right, that's funny because I know Pacifico because that's like all my grandfather drinks.
Oh, okay. So that's just an old man beer then.
Yeah, it's like an old man Mexican beer.
Okay. That's wholesome. Sort of, I guess.
I like how his burrito has like color segmentation on the sauces that they poured over the
top.
Yeah.
That's good. What is this in the foreground though?
This meat looks to be like a steak and shrimp, like a surf and turf thing.
Yeah, but those steaks, I'm not sure about those steaks, man.
It might be a matter of the camera itself. It looks like they might have under contrast. Like it might be more seared off than it looks. You know, like it might look off because of the camera.
Maybe
like Instagram like auto filter look.
Or like if they did like auto HDR, that could fuck up the appearance of food. Like it could be a situation where because shitty cameras do poorly both the shadows and reds, like it could be that steak's gonna look shitty.
Maybe let's move on.
Sure.
Oh yeah, and here's
that's the margarita.
No, this is Ryan Champy. So
Champy.
And we just got, this is a classic classic, what looks like something maybe no, it's not a burrito because it's open on the ends.
Like, is it supposed to be like an enchilada or something?
Yeah, that's what it is. It's an enchilada.
The weird, like, poorly sliced tomato is upsetting. What the fuck?
There's a recurring theme here, yeah.
Yeah, how unsauced is for enchilada? You can see on the back end of the tortilla, there's sauce on that portion, but it's not, like, nearly as sauced as a lot of
that. Yeah, they did a little bit here, and they did a little bit here, yeah. And then it's just the basic Tex-Mex, like, throw a bunch of shit on a plate and go throw it in front of some fat boomer.
It's like 400 permutations of the same five ingredients. Yeah. It's the same thing as when you go out for Italian food. It's like,
that's just what Italian food is.
You know what this platter says to me? This says our cook is getting dope sick. Hurry up, get it done.
Okay. Yeah. Well,
listen, I'm just saying, if you go to a restaurant, there's like a 90% chance that your cook is probably a heroin addict.
Not much from this one, just a poor picture. Oh, okay.
That's very colorful.
Yeah, no, that's actually pretty good. Not happy that the server is wearing a burnt orange, well, not burnt orange, but a Tennessee orange, but I guess, you know, where you are, it could be that way.
I see they have a like a gumball machine too, which is an interesting little addition.
It is on. It's got, oh, guess what time it is, fools? It's Modelo time. Here's another one. Now, this plating is like much more professional looking than all the other ones. Right. What's the date on all the other ones? Were they also 2018?
No, I also find how in this one, in that image,
hold on. Just keep talking. I'm checking something.
In that image of the most recent image of the steak, how the rice has some weird, like almost like fried rice qualities to it in terms of the vegetables they put on top. They put like carrot bits and peas on top.
Okay, I'm looking at the dates here. I'm wondering if this place went under either a change of management or something, because there's been two pictures from 2018, and it was this very fancy plating. The food looks more or less the same, but it's just like the food's plated. This, like, it just looks a little bit more Mexican.
That's what I was talking about. The addition of the vegetables on top of the rice is interesting. That's not happening in other cases of the rice.
Yeah.
I do like that in this case, they put a sliver of lime rather than a random sliver of tomato on the plate. Because I definitely want lime and not tomato.
I'm just wondering if this place underwent some sort of change of management, change of ownership or something.
It's possible.
Yeah, because it seems like like 4 or 5 years ago, they had this, like, the plating was really nice. Then again, this guy's name is Roberto Vinagas. He might just fucking own the place and was just taking
a promotional image then. I gotta say, even for if that is a promotional image, they really could have steered that steak off better. I know that I was saying the whole thing about the camera, but that looks like a situation where the steak was too wet going on the grill or going on the flat top, and it got steamed.
Yeah, and now this picture, I believe, is actually from them, so this is definitely a promotional. But again, you've seen that rice thing. This just looks, I'm not gonna say more authentic, but it just looks less like anything you get everywhere.
Right, and it definitely looks more enticing to eat than some of the random pictures. But
yeah, now this is actually 2022 too, and you're seeing kind of the same stuff. So
now that looks good.
I'm starting to think those other pictures were just promotional.
Right.
So
So I mean, I will say in this case, the piece of meat looks a little bit more browned off. The part sticking out, and
they got some green peppers here.
I mean, it's a nicely stacked plate. It's pushed in together, but it looks all right.
Oh,
that's the flan.
Yeah, but when it's pushed in together, that always gives me the feeling of like that's a home cooked plate. That's that's grandma making sure you get a bit of everything.
Yeah.
Like that doesn't bother me.
Yeah.
From a Mexican place.
Yeah.
So these seem to be flautas.
Yeah. Okay. Those look good.
Those are those enchiladas, or I can't tell if they're supposed to be green enchiladas or smothered flautas.
I think they're flautas. And it looks good, but that was another promotional shot. Here's just another just a bunch of fucking food.
Well, see, in this case, the fajitas are served in the skillet. So
yeah, I'm really thinking that other one was promotional. Someone taking a creep shot of a waitress. Very cool. And that is the end of the photos.
All right, well, do we have any images, any access to their menu? Do they have their website or something?
Let's see. Here's a menu, and it's... Everybody tilt your head real quick because it's the wrong way and you can't even see all of it. I'll check
their way. They're doing fajitas served in a pineapple. That's novel. I've seen that at Asian restaurants or like Polynesian restaurants.
They do have... Oh, okay. They have a website, but does it load? Yeah, here it does. Okay. All right. So, okay. Walk us through this.
That does not look appetizing on the right.
Grilled steak, chicken, and shrimp with cheese dip and pico de gallo on the side.
See what these prices are like, too. I mean, it's not bad.
I mean, it's not. I've seen worse. And I mean, these could be a little old, too. The nachos.
That's not. Treats. They have a lot of random appetizer dips that are basically just meat thrown on top of the queso or whatever.
I mean, hey, if it works. Oh, hey. Look who it is.
Look who it is.
You want to talk about food in Maryville, Tennessee?
Hell yeah.
All right.
If Capri's here, this might get quite heated.
We could get into some shit here. All right. Because, I mean, you two, now we just need, like, too bad Jack's not available for the stream yet. With you three, we would be in here for 5 hours, just you two talking about, just going at it.
Peaches joined the server.
Oh, on God? He was asking about you earlier. He was worried about you. But anyway, we got the nachos. Oh, we got the kids menu, of course. Shout out. I was going to say shout out. They have no chicken finger. No, they do, actually. Fuck. Stop letting them have chicken. Make those little bastards eat something. Fuck you.
Right.
Don't serve ham.
Well, it's not like there's not shit they can eat. I mean, fucking papas con queso. Like just fucking it's fries and cheese. They can eat that.
It's curly fries. Yeah, I don't fucking. What's just all these little picky autistic assholes like, I'm not eating my chicken fingers. Fuck you. You're eating pico de gallo and you're going to like it.
Now, I can't fault a love for chicken fingers, but you do have to branch out and expand your horizons sometimes.
Jack wanted to see the soups. Okay, here's the soups. Chicken soup. Eh. Oh, that's actually the only soup I see.
Well, they have, hold on, the chicken soup.
Seems like the only, there's like, it looks like there's more soups, but that's all I see.
Well, there's a dinner for two. Is that a special that has a label somewhere here?
No. I'm not saying it.
They got the chimichangas. That's nice. And the tacos al pastor, so that's what we saw before.
This looks...
Throw me some tacos al pastor,
this
man.
Is a strange-looking dish right here.
So that's caldo de camarón, which is just seafood soup, basically.
I like that the avatars are actually, like, a little bit messed up. So if you look at the stream... It looks like Capri has like snuck up behind Mez and is about to stab him, and he's right. Not happy about having to do it, but it's the job that he was paid to do.
Mm-hmm. Understand? So. Well, look, if it's Capri, that's fine. I understand.
Yeah, you always wanted to be one of your boys. All right, yeah. I mean, this is a long ass fucking menu. Holy shit!
And you know what? It's missing too. Still it's missing going. Like specials of the week and stuff.
Well, those desserts kind of look decent, actually.
Yeah, that gordita's looks good. By the way, I tell north of the border, I like that. Gorditas. I tell y'all what I've gotten real big into doing lately is cooking my own. What are they called? Oh shit! It's
I
like
don't know, what do they call it?
It's like a gordita shell, but not a gordita. What is that called? Taco Bell has them.
A chalupa.
Chalupa. I've been making my own chalupa shells lately. And those things fuck.
What are you using for them? What's your process?
You know what, though?
I don't know if I can
convince my wife to let me get a Blackstone so I can start making fucking Crunchwraps.
Ooh. Like tostadas. Let's see. It's flour, it's baking powder, and or baking.
So it's like you're making a flour tortilla, but you leaven it a little bit. To get fluffiness. Yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, it's just it has this delicious taste that I just cannot get over. It's so good.
I definitely would say that when they're done right, even at like Taco Bell, the chalupas are one of my favorite evergreen options. And the real tragedy is that at least before my local Taco Bell closed for renovations, every time I went, they would like half-ass frying it, so it would just be like kind of a greasy fucking gordita.
Right. It's like soggy. Yeah,
it fucking sucks. It's like I want the fucking puffy, crunchy bit. Yeah, like, that's what I came for. Nothing,
I would rather have it be over-fried and be like dry than to be fucking soggy.
Wait, if you're gonna give me like a little limp dick piece of shit fucking gordita, then I'm just gonna get a regular taco. I'm not gonna get a fucking chalupa then.
So speaking of tacos, too, here's a little life hack for you guys. If you guys are ever doing taco meat, put in a can a drained black beans, like especially Goya brand. Support Goya, you know, they donate a lot to. They're very good at donating to 45. So.
Mm. Apparently they've been predicting crazy food shortages lately. Yeah.
I tell y'all what my thing has been lately is using better than beef better than bullion beef.
Yes, holy
yeah.
God, I swear by that.
Yeah, yeah. You do about a cup of it and just pour it in with your meat after you've seasoned it and just kind of let it reduce down into the meat. Oh, yeah, my God.
I agree. That's a great way of handling and flavoring it. However, I've been informed recently by Schizos on the Fediverse that those better than bouillon things are, in fact, primarily like soy products or whatever. I don't know.
I don't fucking care. It's delicious. You know what else it is? It's delicious. But... fuck you. I don't care. Yeah, all right. Listen. Let's
some like anti fucking MSG rant or something.
Oh god. Yeah. Well, no.
I love MSG. I'm talking about
listen. We're gonna get it. We'll get on a hold there. Let's just move on. Let's switch up. I see Becky's Grocery and Grill over here.
So okay, it's a little bit of a.
This is a little homey. I like this. It's got the pennants out here. It's got a.
If I'm traveling through Tennessee, this is the kind of place I'm stopping at, right? Like mm-hmm. This is the location.
Let's go.
I'm imagining.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah 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 yeah. Oh right, yeah.
That looks good. Yeah. That looks,
patty
that
melts. A little toasted on the bread. You got the basic ass crinkle fries, but I'm not faulting that. I'm not faulting even.
No, I mean those are coming from like a restaurant depot. Yeah. Like, you can't fault the fries.
No,
unless it's a steakhouse and they're telling you they're making them themselves. Like, I feel like you can't rag on fries.
Here we got a menu, and you know this isn't after 2020 because they've got like notes over the menu where they've had to change it like a bunch of times. although we'll say an 8-ounce monster burger for just under $7 in a touristy area.
Not bad.
That's not terrible. I mean, it's not great, but it's not terrible either. So let's go down this. We get the 8-ounce monster burger, which by shit, okay, just shit. The 4-ounce, the burger on rye, the Ross burger. I don't know what a Ross burger is. Oh, it's pimento cheese.
Okay.
Ground beef on pumpernickel with our homemade pimento cheese. Got a ham on rye. Yeah, yeah, this is too much going on. We got a pecan chicken salad sandwich, BLT, the Reuben, the corned beef. This is like just a deli. This is just a deli, my dude. We got the patty melt. We got the fish. It's just fish. That's it. It's fish. The chuck wagon. The fried grilled chicken. The pork tenderloin. This place. Fuck. Then we got bread choices. We got Jewish rye. We got pumpernickel. We got whole wheat, white, flat bun, Tennessee toast. You want cheeses? Fuck you. We got cheeses. American, pepper jack, Swiss cheddar, homemade pimento.
All right. Where are you looking at?
Join the Discord stream.
Yeah, we got the screen share there. You can view this. They got good options though. Yeah, I mean, it looks like
they got. Oh, I didn't even see the plate lunches. Now they are pricey.
What the fuck? What are these prices, dude? This is like dirt cheap.
Well, this is Tennessee. This is backwoods Tennessee.
It's
not
country, yeah.
Let's
see. What are we getting? We're getting
a meat and three for $12 is not actually bad.
$6.99. Holy crap!
A meat and three is not bad.
And you get the options of catfish, pork tenderloin
for
6 ounces
of catfish. That's not bad.
Do they have shit on a shingle there? I can't look at the menu. I'm driving.
What's shit on a shingle?
You can't. Oh, you won't.
And it includes Tennessee toast or corn muffins. So
what the fuck is Tennessee toast? Is that like Texas toast?
Yeah, it is. That's exactly what it is. That's 100% actually what it is.
Yeah.
They just trying to brand it differently.
It is what it is.
That's a great menu, by the way.
We don't try to call it California.
Oh God, look at that kitchen.
Shut the fuck up.
Look at that kitchen area. We got the folksy signs that say kiss my grits. Dude, this yeah. This is the place.
I think the is that the lady behind the counter is like the old fat black lady who's always talking about her sugars, and when you like you take care now, love.
We got a lady like that at the local Subway. I mean, it's Subway, but she do be like that. I mean, everybody's baby, everybody's precious. Just, you'd love to see it, man. Just some little dessert. Ooh,
like,
okay.
If I go to like a call in uniform, or like go to a deli and pick something up, and the black lady behind the counter is like, "Honey, you take care." She gives me like a big old hug, like she
nice
gives, like, grandma hug and kiss. Then you open your styrofoam like lunch sandwich up, and bro, there's like two servings of fries, an extra half of a sandwich.
Very nice.
The Berg, I'm a little underwhelmed, to be quite honest. I'm a little underwhelmed by this Berg.
I can't complain.
I like smashed burgers.
Yeah, it's definitely like this. I'm looking at just like a Cisco menu right now. That's what I'm looking at. Like, I'm just seeing like everything. Yeah.
What do you mean a Cisco menu?
But I mean, are they going to be doing
SYSCO Cisco, like the restaurant?
Oh, yeah. Right. Okay. Yeah.
What?
Well, I was saying, this isn't the type of place where they would do like smash burgers, right? That's not their image.
What are you talking about?
Ooh, now okay. Now hold on a second. All right, now that's pumpernickel, I'm assuming, that's pumpernickel bread.
Pumpernickel's disgusting.
I actually kind of like pumpernickel.
Nasty. No, that looks disgusting.
I like pumpernickel.
Mez, it's brown. It's this brown ass bread on a burger. It looks like shit.
Okay. All right. Well, we're clearly divided on this one, so.
Burger, and I will declare a fucking fatwa if you disagree with me.
Brioche
and a standard potato roll.
Look,
those are the best.
I agree.
I love these restaurants where they just have like random shit sitting around. I love this. That's good. Oh, and they've got merch. Oh, they've got Boomer merch. Let's go.
It's pretty comfy. This is like
I thought it was hash browns at first. I'm like, no, that's
coconut cream pie.
Yeah.
You
now I get it now. Yes. Hold on. Neat Bucks has just redeemed no cussing. So
listen. Okay, no cussing. Okay.
All right, no cussing.
Well, okay, well,
no cussing.
How long does that last?
I don't know.
These two don't understand a cream pie in any sense.
Oh wow! Okay.
Oh, they're wow!
Shots fired, man. Neat saying potato SpongeBob potato bun or brioche in rare exceptions for burgers. I don't know, man. I would try a brioche burger on pumpernickel.
No, that sounds absolutely
definitely.
Maybe it is. Maybe it is. You know what? Maybe you're right. You might be right.
I swear to God, great Chi-Tan Taylor, if you honestly think pumpernickel deserves to be anywhere near any amount of ground beef, I will give you a taste of my shoe.
All right, fine. I will take a fellow brother's word on this.
Pumpernickel should be reserved for deli meat.
What if it's okay? So what if it's like pumpernickel, like a patty melt? Then like,
what if it's like pumpernickel straight into the garbage, brood? What about that?
What's your problem with pumpernickel?
All I know is I had a pumpernickel sandwich in 2010. With turkey and mayonnaise in, was pretty good. So that's all I'm going to say about
exactly
that.
Exactly. You proved my point. Like I said, it's better with deli meat.
Okay, fine.
I'm still curious.
Yeah, I'm still curious.
I mean, I would.
Look.
It makes a huge part of the burger.
I would throw that burger over the counter and hit the little mama that's cooking.
He would pull up in the drive-thru window with his sirens on, and he would throw the burger inside.
I would just drive through.
I've lost control of the situation.
Well, okay. Well, look at this plate.
Let's just look. All right. Pumpernickel, we're obviously divided on that. A house divided. BMW Civil War. All right, fine. Let's move on.
This is somewhat of a sparse plate, I would say.
Pumpernickel and a burger. Shut the fuck up.
All right, yeah, no. This is a very sparse plate. Is this supposed to be like
bussing, huh?
Breakfast or something?
I think it's supposed to be the like the hamburger steak thing that they do. Oh. I think this might actually be the this might be one of the meat and threes.
That's not a hamburger steak. That's not a hamburger steak.
But if you recall, go back to the meat and threes on the menu. They have hamburger steak as an option with those sides.
I know what it is. That's liver mush.
I don't think that was even on the menu.
Look up there. Look, 1/2 pound hamburger steak with grilled onions and cheese. I feel like that's what that is.
Yeah, I don't.
And then you get the two sides, which are the green beans and the hash brown things, and then you also get the corn muffin there, and that's what they're having.
Okay. All right. Well, that's a really pathetic.
Yeah, it's a little underwhelming, I gotta say.
Yeah.
Not as underwhelming as the pumpernickel burger.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Nasty. I gotta see how bad their Google profile picture is. Go back to that.
Oh, let's see. Let's X out of it. What do you mean? Like it's just the outside of it.
Because we were looking at their profiles before.
Oh, I understand what you mean. Okay, let me get back to that then. Hold on. The person who took it. I haven't seen
many.
I thought you meant
like,
the restaurants. I don't know why. Of what the.
Like the pictures that show up on the upper left for the people posting the images.
It's just a D. Like it's a default one. They don't actually have one. Yeah.
The default.
Okay, well, I'm just moving past that since that's controversial. What is this?
This is the Reuben, I think.
Yeah.
What kind of Reuben is this?
Yeah. This place.
Bro.
I'm iffy on this place.
I mean, you don't go to a southern place to get a Reuben. I mean, you
okay,
go
that's
to
all
a
the pictures.
This isn't fucking New York.
And what's crazy
what
is this place has 253 reviews and it's a 4.8.
That's a lot. That's a lot for this kind of area.
And it looks like garbage. Like I'm.
No, it means the food's really good.
Oh, okay. It just looks terrible. All right. Well, that's fine.
I mean, you know,
if you got 258 reviews in the middle of fucking nowhere.
Oh, this Mexican place had No, we weren't at Poncho's.
Oh, don't forget.
Was Poncho's?
No,
it wasn't Poncho's.
It may not be the best food, but it could be really consistent. Like you always know, it's always going to be a 3.5 out of 5. You know, like
Las Margaritas.
Based on this location.
Yeah, Las Margaritas had 1,100 reviews, and it's relatively out there. Like it's still in the city.
If you look on the map.
1,100,
Becky's Grill, there's like nothing else within like probably 5 miles.
No, Becky's Grill is truly out. Like, yeah, like here's East Lamar Parkway. Yeah, that's a huge thoroughfare, but they're off a road that's off a road, and then at the junction of another road. So, yeah, I mean, they're like here, let's put this in perspective by looking at the satellite. Like, they are out there in the.
It's the local watering.
I've looked at this before. Yeah. This you're absolutely right, Maz. This is like the local watering hole. So it's like this is kind of a suburban area a little bit. So like this right here, this you can see this on the satellite. This begins
the local hole.
This begins like the mountains, air quotes, because this is
some characters in there.
What pass is it? Melrose Pass? No, it's got
a
different name.
Like your mother, it's the local hole. So
got him.
We get it.
Got him. but yeah, okay. So yeah, that explains a lot about that. Let's move on here. This is getting heated. All right, we're moving a little bit into town. Bojangles, Sonic. Okay, this one, the Walnut Kitchen, 588 reviews, 4.5. It's looking like it's a meat market, in addition to a place to eat.
Well, let's evaluate the meat then.
$3 signs, though. You know what that means.
Well, maybe, you know.
Yeah.
Selling premium. I mean, that ribeye is, what, 22 a pound?
That was 2018, though, so.
Well, yeah, so it's a little bit more than that now.
Yeah.
It does look like decent meat.
Now, shout out, they sell Benton's, which is a local butcher place. They do a killer bacon. They're literally just down 411, like 30 minutes down the road. So supporting local business, you love to see it. That's just a salad. Okay.
Well, there's some decent stuff in there. Like you got walnuts, you got, looks like cheese crumbles, you got apples.
I'm sorry,
that kind of
that's
salad.
Bad looking, man.
That's a decent looking salad. Yeah.
And they probably charge like $10 for it, too.
And
so.
they got the cranberries. Ooh. On it. That's fine.
Okay, now that's a decent looking steak. That's a decent looking steak. That's a good looking baked potato. I'm liking everything I see here. It's the person that took this picture sucks. Steve Burnett. Well, that's weird. That's weird because if you go to his actual profile, like his picture is. Yeah, look at his reviews are like all over the place. One's down in the Virgin Islands. This dude's probably a sex tourist. I don't know that. For legal reasons, that's a joke. For legal reasons, that's a joke.
to have sex, Taylor. Obviously.
All right, I'm gonna move past that. Okay. Ooh, okay. Now that's interesting.
There's a lot going on here.
Let's break this one down for us.
It looks like
gonna break it down. Okay. That's a ribeye roast, a 2-bone ribeye roast, sure, with fucking strawberries on top, which is the dumbest fucking thing.
Okay.
Is that potatoes?
That's definitely potatoes.
Strawberry reduction at the bottom with the roasted potatoes.
That is an interesting choice.
One out of five capris. Choice. What are you giving that plating?
The plating is not terrible. It's just strawberries on ribeye. Like, that's the bad part.
Oh, okay.
I wouldn't
do that. If the reduction contained other things, maybe it would taste all right. Maybe it's not
like a lot of garlic, I mean, if it was a savory thing. Okay. The sides look fine.
This looks like a filet mignon or something with some roasted asparagus.
That's a big boy potato there.
Is that white sesame seeds on top of the asparagus?
I think it is, yeah. That is a wide fucking boy. Oh, that reminds me. I forgot to find that wide boy in that anime earlier. Oh, whatever. I'll link it in Discord.
We'll see
later.
Some other time.
I'll link it. He's a wide boy. It's great. Yeah, no, but this is you'd love to see it. You'd love to see it. Oh, okay.
That's getting like small plate bullshit. Yeah. That's like.
I'm not certain about that.
Fuck it. Is this a dessert or is this a savory thing?
It might be another thing like the ribeye with the strawberries. They might be doing like a sweet and savory thing.
Looks like a fucking coffee cream and like a caramel drizzle. It's like,
Jack, fuck, is that chicken wings? What the fuck?
It almost looks
this?
Like pheasant or something.
Yeah,
Jack saying a cherry reduction would be better, but leaving the fruit intact is a major no-no. Yeah, that just...
Yeah, I think that was an interesting
weird
choice for sure. Okay, it's like charcuterie.
Yeah, a little charcuterie board. I don't hate it.
They got the stone, like the coarse ground mustard, which I always like.
Shout out, this person's name is Jillian Klan, KLAN. So that's a weird name, but okay, whatever. Go off, queen. Oh, that fucking cornbread, my dude.
Mm.
Oh, and is that homemade butter? That looks like homemade butter.
Yeah, that's the texture. Yeah,
That's homemade butter, my dude. Ooh. Oh my god, holy shit.
Well, I was gonna say, it could also be a compound butter. It looks like could be a situation they reconstituted it with maple syrup or some shit, which happens often.
This fucking steak.
That is a big boy
In 2021, this motherfucker costs $75 easily.
Right.
What is this?
That looks like fried potatoes.
Well, I was gonna say, sweet potatoes, I think, actually.
Maybe it's hard to tell because they browned it up.
Is that okra? I think that's okra. Can I zoom in? Yeah, here we go. That's a little bit of okra, and then I can't tell what that is.
Oh, yeah, that one's a little hard to tell.
It almost looks like mushrooms, but I don't think
it could be. Yeah.
Drinks.
I really need to see the menu for the prices here. I'm curious about.
What is it like a pound cake?
Something like that. Yeah. Like maybe a carrot cake?
Ooh, now, okay. This is just a really shitty photo, but
yeah, it looks like the only light source is the fucking camera because they use like shitty flash.
This, I mean, is this supposed to be like mac and cheese or something? Like a really fancy mac and cheese? I think so. $3 signs is pushing $50 to $60 plate minimum.
That's not unexpected, I guess.
Yeah, but. Well, I mean, this place is much. Oh, now the plating on that looks very nice, but again, it almost looks like there's maple syrup on this.
No, but if that's the extent of the sweet element in a fried chicken dish, then I can accept that.
And they're adding a hot element because look, there's a little bit of jalapeno down here.
Right. So, or maybe it's like a hot honey situation.
That's what it is. Like, you know what? Yeah. These are like they're like fried almost. I think.
Yeah, it's like an interesting kind of like cone style fry, and they do the thing where they make it like a chicken lollipop by pushing the meat down.
Oh, okay, well, that's interesting. Ooh, hello. Now this is looking like some sort of like cheese bake thing.
I can tell you right now, those look like kind of on site prepared chips.
Yeah, because they definitely are.
And they look like they were taken a little too far. I gotta say, I feel like
they're a little brown. Yeah, they're a little brown.
They're gonna have that little bit of acrid burnt flavors going on.
I wouldn't say that, but they could have been pulled a minute earlier.
Maybe with the sauce it's safe.
Okay, now here's a decent looking. Well, that's actually cabbage, I think.
No, that's just I think that's just an iceberg wedge or whatever. That's a wedge salad.
Okay, I'll take your word for that. That looks like an okay salad. These people look pretentious as fuck. pictures outside. Yeah, it's a nice looking place. I'll say that. It's a little modern looking.
Is that fried okra or fried pickles?
It's either fried okra or fried pickles. I can't tell which.
Like, I think the texture looks okra-ish, but
I think it's okra. I think you're right.
No, that's not okra.
You sure?
Well, what is it, Capri? What is
that's not okra.
Is it fried zucchini?
I think that's okra. Is. I'm pretty sure that's okra.
No, that's not okra.
Well,
dude.
let's check the menu. See if we can find a menu.
Well, they might have multiple fried things on the
here
menu.
Here we go. All right, main course. Oh, okay, so here we can actually see. And these prices are not terrible, actually.
Let's see the steaks.
okay.
Because a la carte, they're quite, the filet is $40, but
that's not the worst I've ever heard. Yeah. Okay, here's appetizers. Let's see. Pecan bread. Fried chicken lollipop halves. You're absolutely right. Tennessee all natural chicken, honey, chilies, and thyme. You're absolutely right on that, Prude.
That price is not that terrible for them. For their presentation, if the full order is $12, that's not that bad, actually.
For both of those? Oh, for half is, so what's half?
It's like you get a half order of them. Like you get half as many. So if they serve, I don't know, however many, you get half of that.
I'm actually not seeing any vine pear pie.
Where'd Mez go?
No, well, he's on the road, so he probably had to leave.
I think he went to eat. He was probably eating, actually.
He went and got Wendy's.
I'm not seeing anything fried here, so maybe it's somewhere else. Shareable. There's that. Well, that's the same thing, actually.
Akasha. Oh, yeah, same.
Well, no, it's not. This is it. Oh, sweet. They're doing that street corn. Street corn is huge now.
Yeah. So, like the elotes type stuff?
Yeah.
Where it's like, yeah.
Cocktails, don't care.
Not that expensive either.
Cocktails, don't care.
All accounts. This is definitely less pricey.
Terrible
than
fucking
I would
pictures,
expect.
Don't care. Oh, God. Jesus Christ. Can someone just. That's not even a. Okay, it just happens to have a menu in the picture. Fuck you, Google. Fuck you, Google. I can't read any of this.
Oh, man. I will say sometimes Google compresses them in such a way that they're actually easier to read once you kind of zoom slightly.
I think it was tempura pickles, sweet soy, Thai chili, and ginger. Because if you recall in that picture.
No, that's what it is, yeah.
In that all picture, right. There was... Yeah. If you look at this picture again.
Because of the sauce, yeah. Okay.
Tempura pickles, so we were all wrong.
And that explains why it has the weird fried texture, because it's tempura, right? It's not just a normal. Right. It's not the underlying substance.
Yeah. Reviews are very, very positive for this. Great food, great service, real nice place to eat with family and friends. Great selection of wine, beer, and liquor. Oh, God, they're a drinker. Ugh.
fucking drunkers.
Dude, I'm going to drink. All right, we'll move on from that.
We got Buster's Real Ice Cream down there, or Brewster's Real Ice Cream down there.
Brewster's
the highway.
Real, yeah. Let's just say,
you don't know Brewster's.
Let's switch it up a little bit and go to Brewster's real quick.
So we can get through this. Oh,
that's
nice,
Sunday. Yeah. I could get down with that.
I have to say, though, I feel like there's really few times where I'd ever look at a picture of like an ice cream concoction and be like, oh, that fucking sucks. Like, you know,
yeah.
Like how often is it going to be like, oh, that just looks like shit, you know? It all
well,
looks fine,
I mean,
usually.
You know. Hiring assistant manager a year and a half ago, or you know, not quite a year. This just looks like real. You're right. Like you can't look at a picture of ice cream and go like one way or the other.
That thing on the right with like it's like a peanut butter chocolate thing. That looks good.
Yeah, it does actually look pretty good. A scoop above the rest. I like that.
It's a nice little tagline.
Oh God, bunch of boomery signs. Save the planet. It's the only one with chocolate. Fuck off. Oh God! Look at this, Jesus Christ!
She wants that,
dude. that face when you're ready to go into diabetic shock. What fucking shirt is she wearing? Oh, it's like an Alice in Wonderland thing.
Mm. Oh yeah, with the little caterpillar. Yeah.
Kid picture. It's like some kid shit or something. Oh yeah, look at this back. The back area. That's great.
They got a decent selection then. That's a lot of little compartments.
But look at these people. Like he doesn't want to be there. She's suicidal. They're high. This place. Yeah, this place is great. Oh. Now that's
I gotta disagree with that.
You don't like this?
Putting cereal as a topping on like any dessert fucking sucks because the cereal is always gonna suck more than the thing you're putting it on. So like it just kind of detracts from the experience.
Okay.
But.
Oh, what's that?
What?
What?
What Prue just said?
I don't know.
It's gonna fucking suck. You can put fucking Oreos on it. It'll be 10 times better. Than
I just ignored everything he said. I'm just moving on. What is this fried element here?
I guess maybe that's what they're going for, like a fried ice cream, like pastry and ice cream.
I guess, yeah. Yeah, a bunch of interior shots on this one. Oh,
Mint is a classic.
Oh, by the way, put his Porsche key. God, I fucking hate. Oh, by the way, the Porsche is in the fucking background. I fucking hate this guy.
I love it.
Does he have a picture of you? No, he's not.
Dave Hudge, this guy.
Does a fucking review.
Fuck this guy. The only thing that would have made it worse if he was in the handicap spot. Jesus, what a prick. And that's the end of it. Yeah,
ice cream's a safe thing to do. I feel like if you're trying to like sell food and you don't know what to do, I feel like ice cream's pretty safe because how are you gonna fuck it up unless you're like putting like E. coli in your ice cream or something? You know?
1,000, almost 1,100 reviews at 4.6. But again, you know, how do you fuck up that?
Right.
It's Brewster's. Do you not have Brewster's in your area?
No, here's an idea.
Wait, hold on. Is Brewster's a chain?
Yeah.
Oh,
well, it
has to be a regional chain then.
Yeah,
it is.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'll allow that.
Oh, how about that Buddy's barbecue right there? Look at that.
Let's do a barbecue. Let's do a barbecue. Yeah. Actually, is this
not Buddy's?
I think this might be a chain too. Actually,
Buddy's.
I said Buddy's.
This is a chain. Fuck this. We're not doing chains.
Fucking
chain. Oh, but this one, the Shed Smokehouse and Juke Joint.
This looks more interesting. Anyways.
This looks, all right. 4.7, 4.3. It's only two number dollar signs, so that's not too bad. Well, I'm already,
I like that interior.
I'm already seeing some shit I like. They got ESPN on. They got like a map. I love it. Yeah, this place has character.
They got please order here.
Ooh, that's hello.
Beefy sandwich.
That's a beefy sandwich. What?
Did you say it's bad?
It's bad, yeah.
God, shut the fuck up.
Okay, what's wrong with it?
Why would you put that much barbecue sauce? Like, you don't do it like that.
It's just drizzle over the top. It's
No. You don't understand. He's from North Carolina. They have their own barbecue thing.
He wants the North Carolina vinegar sauce or whatever. Ugh. Fucking.
What do we have here?
To put that much sauce on a sandwich, it means your meat is just okay.
I'd still eat it.
Jack said 10 out of 10 atmosphere would get absolutely embarrassing drunk with the boys at win.
That also, this is not traditional, but this brisket French dip looks quite good.
It actually really does. Yeah. I love a good French dip. Oh shit. And we got
just need.
That's what I thought it said too. I mean, it says the Shed, but obviously no, it's the Sneed. Yeah, it says that's the name of the place, the Shed Smokehouse and Juke Joint.
It could also say the Sneed.
It probably says the Sneed, actually. Now that if we're being honest.
Is Mez trying to get back in? He's in the waiting room.
Are
you trying to get back in?
Yeah, I got him. I'm good. I gotta give him the role. I'm gonna create like a co-host role too for people.
Make a role, like a gay role for Mez.
I've already got plenty of those for you. That's cool. Oh shit, do they just have fucking like, oh no, this is a Harley store. I don't know why this picture's on here.
Fucking boomers.
Oh, dude, this place is the joint.
Yeah,
dude, look at this place. It's a whole venue. Okay.
Huh. Oh, it's like an outdoor music stage.
This is. Oh, you know what? It must be right next to the Smoky Mountain.
Did this used to be a Chinese restaurant? Look at that fucking dragon.
No, I think that's just some stupid Harley thing. Yeah.
No, that it used to be a Chinese restaurant.
Oh, maybe the Shed. Yeah. Oh God, Jesus Christ. How boys? How many beers?
Six or seven.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, hold on. How about for her?
Oh, that's 14. What we're talking about. Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
Oh, now I'm talking about the old one.
14.
The younger one.
Well,
I don't know
keep in mind
that.
She does have a hand tattoo, so.
Right.
But she's. I mean, she's okay, I guess. Oh, hey, guys, I think we have too many megapixels in this picture. If we could bring this down by another 10 or so, I think we'd really begin somewhere.
Is this like knockoff Willie Nelson?
Oh, guys, we have a video.
Where is this?
Guys, we have a video.
This is in Maryville.
Snake fuck. Did he just say shit fuck?
No audio. Yeah, we can't get audio on.
Oh, sorry.
Bowman Twitch and
I don't know what he's saying.
Type in sweet peas.
What the fuck is sweet peas?
Sweet pea. It's a really good barbecue place in Knoxville.
I want to see more of this place's barbecue.
Yeah, I want to see more of the food, but they don't like I'm just gonna go
sweet peas, dude.
Dude, I will go to sweet peas in a minute. Shut the fuck up.
There's I'll a slap menu you. And the food and drink.
Here we go. Okay,
yeah,
here we go.
Those first few.
That's not sweet peas for sure.
Oh, we got little pretzel bites. Okay.
Is it like beer cheese or something?
Beer cheese, yeah. Beer cheese.
Beer cheese is good.
It is good.
It is. Yeah. What is it? It's Screaming Sicilian Pizza, like a frozen pizza. They have like a pub pizza. It's great. It's really good.
I have
actually
their pepperoni in the freezer.
Oh, what is it? What are we doing here?
This is like healthy like options, right?
It's
like,
oh, fuck off.
You go there and in some
woman's
being
food.
A woman.
That's not food.
Yeah.
That's technically food, I guess. Ooh. Okay. Oh, man, we got some real
dry. That chicken looks dry.
Yeah.
That's way too well.
Yeah, it does actually look a lot. Yeah.
Okay, but I'm not going there for chicken, so let's,
yeah,
you know.
So that looks a little better, but mm-hmm. I can just tell that barbecue's a little dry.
Well, it's dry, but you know what else? It's just this is a really bad pizza. It's like they're taking an Android or something, not a good new Android, like an old Android. You want to know why I know it looks like a bad old Android? Because I got about 1,000 fucking pictures from 2010 that I took on mine. That's how I know what it looks like. Oh, well, now that we kind of put the... Is this like a perspective issue, or is that just a real... Is that like a...
Fat hand, wee-woo, fat fingers.
Wee-woo.
I think he might be using, like, a wide angle, vertical, so it's creating distortion.
I thought that was like a Naya sandwich or something.
Look, it's healthy. It's healthy. He's got a diet.
Oh, yeah, he's got to have the diet. This is Donald Trump. It might actually be because his profile picture is extremely fucking patriotic. If it'll pull up. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm voting for. I don't know what that guy's running for.
He looks like he'd be like a grifter lawyer that Donald Trump hired at some point.
Well, you know, funny you mentioned that.
He looks like a character from a Duke Nukem game.
Funny you mentioned that. He's up in this area and he's not far from a, what's his name?
Food?
No. Oh God, what was his name?
5,000 beds.
Well, how am I forgetting? Lockwood. He's not far from Jim Lockwood.
Jim
Lockwood was in. Where the hell is? Oh God, where the hell is Notre Dame?
Is Notre Dame up there?
Yeah, it's around here somewhere. Uh-huh. Columbus. I don't fucking. It's somewhere around here. So yeah, I mean he's probably in league with Jim Lockwood.
Why did I think Notre Dame was in like Arizona?
South Bend, Indiana. That's where it is. South Bend, Indiana. Yeah.
I can't get over how dry that chicken looks, man. That's fucking sad.
Yeah.
If you go to order chicken at a barbecue restaurant, you're a piece of shit anyways. So.
Yeah, I'm not. Smokey's Pizza, that sounds like a chain.
That does sound.
I don't know, but it's in a really non-chain looking place, though.
Now, where's the sweet peas?
Where's Sweet Pea? Oh, it's in Knoxville, so it doesn't count. Oh, no, this is definitely fucking local. It's got two. All right, we'll look at it. We haven't seen a pizza place yet. It's got a 3.8, though, but I feel like people's opinions on pizza are very mercurial.
I feel like people will just be fucking stoked if they have any pizza at all, even if it sucks. Mm-hmm. So, like, it's not easy to tell.
Yeah, I don't.
Sometimes.
That looks like a stock photo. okay. I mean.
That is a sad fucking looking pizza, but then again, I'm speaking through a Jersey lens.
Yeah, I mean, it looks all right to me.
That's a bad picture, but I would probably get that too.
It looks okay. It's a bad picture. Oh, okay, now that looks better.
That's like a fucking shawarma roll. Like
it is a little bit, yeah. Yeah. Ooh, look at that fucking cheesy bread. Yeah, okay.
They did a good job with the cheese on that one.
They did, yeah.
What is this fucking Middle Eastern shit?
I don't know.
That's a fucking gyro. That is a sad looking fucking...
Yeah, again, a lot of it's the camera.
I think you can salvage that meatball sub if you put pepperoni on it, though.
This is just a big old greasy burg, looks like.
Mm. This place has an interesting menu for...
It does.
It's supposed to be pizza.
Ooh, hello. What is this? Is this just like
chicken parm? It's just chicken parm without a sandwich.
Oh god, I do love chicken parm.
A little
if it's any good.
A little Kaiser salad on the side with Newman's Own, by the way. Shout out. Newman's Own is delicious. Oh, that's the last picture. No, it's not. Oh, I clicked. That's a stock photo.
What the fuck is going on?
I don't know. Yeah, that's a healthy looking burger. And with wedge potatoes? What is going on?
And it looks sufficiently crispy too. So.
It does, yeah. It looks like
double fried.
Looks, yeah.
Looks like shit.
What is going on at this place? This guy, yeah, someone, no. Someone said, it's like, someone asked this guy, it's like, what kind of restaurant do you want to open? Yes.
It kind of puts me on edge though, because if a place tries to do too many things, I don't trust that it's going to be doing any well. Yeah.
What is this?
It looks like a hash brown, my man.
That is okay. That's not.
Well, that would be like a breadstick. That's fucked. Oh, I don't know. Oh,
yeah, that's just part of the chicken parm. Okay, that was the last photo. Let's see what the. I'm curious what the reviews have to say about this place.
Yeah, we should probably read some of the reviews for these places to see the actual words being used. Okay. Too.
Don't read Google reviews. Read Yelp reviews.
I'm not going
Google
to Yelp.
Reviews are usually, yeah, fuck Yelp.
I'm not going to Yelp. But this is the whole point Google of this reviews. Is we're using Google. Actually, so all the. Oh, here we go. Okay, so seriously, for the cost of a salad, you would think that they would take the time to pick out the bad lettuce and to cut it into small pieces, but evidently this fact had to disappoint it.
Well, okay, so the bad lettuce thing...
They gave him a whole ass leaf, though. They just gave him a fucking leaf.
They just
leaf.
Gave that dude a straight up leaf.
Well, okay, so that sucks, but at the same
well,
time...
it's his fault. You don't go to a place like this and order the goddamn
well, yeah,
salad.
Well, yeah. Jesus Christ, fucking paragraph from the owner. Why didn't you call the store and ask for a remake on the salad? Generally, you get more results if you call and say something about the problem. We'd love.
He's fucking right.
He's right, yeah. No, yeah, like, when you fuck up, you go to them first, and then in the review, you say, they fucked it up, they did it better, 3 stars. You know, something like that.
That's peak California cry about everything fucking mindset.
Well, let's look at this. Look at this guy.
Management.
Hey, I don't do that.
California.
Oh, God. Oh.
I'm pretty sure I seen him on a sex offender registry.
Yeah, I was about to say. I'm sure. I wonder if I look him up on the sex offender. If he gives a lot of 3 stars,
that's my
actually.
Uncle.
That's my, it might be.
Is that coming segment like offender that's registry review?
I mean, next week on the Beefcast,
I'd watch that.
Review the New Jersey State Police's sex offender registry.
I mean,
sure.
That's not a terrible idea.
Could be kind of funny.
That's not.
That might be construed as harassing them, which might be legally.
No, it's not. Boo hoo, you're a fucking chomo. You don't have rights.
It's public information. It's not.
I'm just saying, because I know there's laws against going and harassing, using that information to harass them.
So Jack saying, I never.
Look, I would only suggest going to harass them. I would never condone harassment.
California.
We'll put a disclaimer down at the bottom that says, you know, don't
do not contact these people and fuck with them or whatever.
Like, what do you think the registry is for, dude?
I don't think legally it's for that.
Yeah. But anyway, sorry, Jack saying he said I never bitch unless there's something seriously fucked up about my meal, like a booger or a massive hair. Or it's completely the not something I ordered or whatever. If they gave me that as a salad, I'm taking that back. Like that's bitch worthy.
Sure. Yeah. I mean.
Yeah.
That's pretty obvious.
So it looks like we got here. This looks like a more like upscale kind of place. I'm using upscale in quotation marks, but this looks
sweet
like
peas.
They. Fuck off! We're not doing sweet peas. It's in Knoxville. We'll do sweet pea
like
at the
20
end.
20 minutes away.
We'll
Come
do
on.
Sweet pea at the end. We'll do sweet pea at the end. Fuck
yeah. Yeah, look at that big old boy filling up his soda.
Oh,
though.
Yeah, that's a beer. That's a Pilsner gut right there.
Oh, what is he? I can't see. Is he getting water? Is he trying to be fucking
healthy?
No,
he's getting ice. He's getting ice.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, but this looks like a more like traditional kind of place. You know, we got the Italian colors, painted
fresh. It almost looks like something from Jersey.
Yeah.
Almost.
Ooh, okay. Look at. Okay.
Nah.
That's like bruschetta garlic bread.
And this is smothered
weird.
In cheese. I don't know.
And it's not even crisped up. Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah.
That doesn't look good.
Yeah. That looks good only because the lighting is well done.
What the fuck is
that? That's just all cheese. That's just all cheese.
This
is too much fucking cheese. Yeah, no, this... bitch is on the cell phone. What
was that, a fucking big calzone?
I think it's a big calzone, yeah.
But it's not even toasted, bro. That shit's gotta get toasted. Too much cheese on that. Too much cheese.
What is
that?
That's a loaded fucking slice.
That's a loaded slice.
That's disgusting, bro. That's looking pepperoni.
What is this? How are you gonna run a place that looks like this and then fuck it. And the worst part is this place is higher rated than the other one.
Look, there's no accounting for the general public's taste.
don't use Google reviews.
So here's a question though. Since we've been talking about restaurant or hospital restaurants lately, is there a local hospital we can?
There actually is. Yeah, Blount County Hospital is right here.
Let's see if there's any pictures of the food there.
That's actually a good idea. I'm just gonna see.
It might be in the medical complex as well. There's several things if you zoom in.
I don't actually see anything specifically about. And usually cafeterias are in the hospital proper, so.
Yeah, just
no, I'm not saying anything.
I have one. I just don't know if it's gonna be itemized as.
I don't know how many people are in a hospital cafe going, I should review this place. You know what I mean?
Sure. It's worth a try.
Duncan. Okay, now here's a fine dining place. This looks more up Capri's alley. And by
that we're stereotyping.
No.
This is asparagus, spears, and what kind of cut of steak is that?
It's a New York strip.
Okay.
Yeah.
This place is a little fancy.
You kind of already dug into it a little bit, which you know makes it hard to evaluate the plating there.
No. Yeah. Oh, that's.
No.
No. No. This, no.
This
on is, that.
This looks a little too pretentious for me. I gotta say.
Yeah. I would not eat it. This place looks terrible.
I thought you were one of these pretentious people. Oh, that looks good though.
Yeah, but.
Here's the thing: is Capri doesn't want the stereotypical pretentious food. He wants the foods he likes done pretentiously.
Oh,
no. That's you, Prude. I just want them done right.
You're gonna talk about the regional specialties.
Arugula off my burger.
Yeah.
Jack.
Yeah, I got cheese and arugula, pickled beets.
Jack said,
I got lychee on my burger.
Jack said, the hospital reviews seem like it'd be an entertainment segment. The food sucked and they killed my mom.
What is this little pastry supposed to be?
I don't know. Fuck this place. I don't want to see this anymore. No, fuck this place. I don't care anymore.
Sweet peas, bro.
Fuck sweet peas. I'm not. We'll do sweet peas at the end. Fuck you.
Hot 50s Diner, Waterfront Bar and Grill. Yeah. This place is there.
Yeah, we'll do it. Holy shit.
What's Bullpen? That's another one to consider down there.
That sounds like an American style place.
Sweet peas is like 20 minutes away from where
Hot Rod's 50 Diner, 2,600 reviews. Holy shit.
This might be a little tourist trappy, I gotta say.
It might be, but sometimes those places still have. Oh, yeah. Uh huh. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Look. Oh, my. Look at the size of those lads.
That shit's is beer battered. Look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's beer battered.
Oh, yeah.
This place looks legit.
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely a tourist trap for like boomers. You can just tell they're doing that, but. Oh,
that doesn't mean the food's bad.
Look at those fry portions. The Frito chili cheese pie. Oh my, this looks actually pretty okay.
Those rings do look great. Yeah.
I would put the rings on the burger to be quiet. Yeah, Jack's giving it a 10. Oh Jesus Christ!
That fry on the meat.
Jesus Christ, that looks good. A little dry with no condiments, but whatever.
Well, you can get condiments. You don't
got to
do it that way.
Oh, hello. Okay. Nice. Yeah. Okay. I'm thinking.
Check out sweet peas.
shut the fuck off. Look at the sweet potato fries. Okay, yeah. Not bad. I like these like homemade like cut for
home chips. Yeah. House chips.
Yeah. Oh, and a jalapeno burger. Yeah. Okay.
I love me some jalapeno. Yeah. Cheese fries or chili or bacon cheese fries? I can't.
Bacon cheese fries.
Yeah.
And they also, I think these are sweet potatoes fries.
And just looking at the ranch, I can just tell that's decent ranch.
It's probably Sysco ranch, but Sysco ranch fucks. Absolutely fucks. Right. Shout out to the trash can, I guess. Oh, hello.
This fucking car.
Fucking hot run. That was kind of cool. That was the end of the picture, unfortunately.
Don't eat here if you don't have a car like this.
Yeah. I see down the street we have subs and such. We want to do sandwich.
I actually want to look at this real quick. A Jamaican place?
Why don't we check out Sweet Peas?
Shut the fuck up! You know what? We're not doing Sweet Peas. I was going to do it at the end. We're not even doing it now. Are you happy?
Check it out.
All right, we'll check it out at the end. So this is what do y'all know about Jamaican?
Oh no,
I know Jamaican patties.
I used to live in the islands. Yeah, that's
God. Where haven't you fucking lived? Jesus Christ!
Yeah, I lived. I lived on a
Jamaican crazy.
Fuck off! Fuck off!
You didn't know that.
Fuck off! Fuck off! This
I lived on an island called Nevis.
Fuck off! You lived on an island called My Balls, you dumb bitch.
No, it's called Nevis. It sucked. I mean,
this mac and cheese looks pathetic.
That chicken would be looking good, though. That chicken looking good.
Yeah, because Jamaicans do like to blacken the meat.
Jamaicans are black. Nice. There's just straight Goya rice and beans.
Though. Yeah. Look how small it is.
I think it's an amusing little.
It is.
If it's got good jerk seasoning.
Wait, what the fuck? They got good jerk.
What is this fucking House of Leaves bullshit?
What the fuck is sci-fi inside. Shit? That was a goddamn TARDIS. That's got to. What? That doesn't make any sense.
It's
that doesn't make any fucking sense. It has to be. Okay. Hold on. Let's check the satellite image to explain this bullshit. Hold on. We got a satellite. Oh, okay.
That's big enough to accommodate that photograph.
What?
Wait, did the building get in another image? There was like the little shack on the outside was separated. Now it's like attached.
Yeah.
It grew.
I wonder if they like tore it down. And then, hold on, let me check the dates on this, actually. That would probably
be if that little bitch one was earlier.
Okay, so this is 2016, this outside picture. Yeah, all these outside pictures. Oh, well, that's an outside. No, that's inside. 2022, 2019.
Okay, this is...
So that was August 2019.
The dates are lagging. This is
and this is March 2022. They must right. have, and this
yeah,
looks
they expanded. That means yeah. that it's a good place. They yeah. made enough money to expand.
You're absolutely yeah. right. That's a strange plating, but okay, whatever.
That pulled pork looks good.
It does actually. Yeah, it looks very wet.
It looks moist.
I don't know how I feel about this though.
It looks like they might be doing something different than standard mac and cheese. The texture wise, I think they might be putting something else in it.
Yeah. Oh, hey, now hiring 5 years ago. But then again, I mean, these days, they're probably still hiring.
That pork looks a little bit less moist.
But it still looks moister. It still looks moister than the other place we were looking at earlier.
A lot of sauce on the side if you want sauce. So, yeah. I mean.
That looks very dry.
Yeah.
But that's more like a cutlet. So, I mean, I guess. Ooh, those fries look good.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, this place looks pretty good. That looks pretty good.
It's decent.
Yeah.
Someone's on the job though. Fucking.
Yeah, I saw. I was about to say. I was waiting for you to make a comment.
Fucking radio.
Yeah, this place looks all right. All right.
Was that collards on the side?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's Jamaican.
Hey,
so.
Check out Sweet Peas.
Okay, we'll check out Sweet Peas real quick.
Subs and such is right up there.
Soup kitchen. That's
let's get the soup and sandwiches here.
Okay. Let's get a little soup and sandwiches. 4.6, 305 reviews. Calderwood Street. Now this is technically Alcoa, which I think is just another like Seymour or something.
It's like a little suburb area. It counts.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's within the area.
Cool. I like the billboards here behind it. And
Tanger Outlets.
Yeah. Chili? Yeah, something like that.
Something red.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you for that.
Oh, no.
I don't
like this.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
That's a chunky
tomato soup, and I don't know how I feel about that.
That's a chili. That's not a tomato
soup. You sure?
Yeah, that's
good. Then it got a grilled cheese with it, though.
Yeah, grilled cheese edition.
You got cheese there. You got sour
Fritos.
Cream.
They got the Fritos.
Yeah.
So I suppose you're right.
Yeah.
Is that a little Reuben?
Nah, nigga.
Whoa. Remember we're on Twitch.
You're right.
Sorry. For record, Twitch, Capri's black. He can say that. Yeah, it looks like a Reuben. I mean, that's a decent Reuben, I guess. I guess. Yeah.
No, dude. I'm not. It's not a decent.
Oh, look at this dry ass looking corn. No. You can't show a boy straight out of the sip some dry ass cornbread and expect him.
Right. Well, let's check out subs and such right there. I want to see what the subs are looking like.
It was looking very dry overall. Sub, you know, for such. A soup place, you wouldn't expect that.
All right, we got a $1 sign, 4.5 and 1,000 reviews.
That's a good place.
That's a good place.
Simple interior. That's all I need.
Simple interior.
Jobs.
You got your coolers with some water and a bunch of chips. Hello.
Oh,
that's a big old sandwich.
Now that I tell you what, that looks like some good bread, like some decent bread. It's probably
it's got some texture.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably
yeah.
still like a Cisco or something, but it's like a their better selection.
It's full up, man. I like seeing pictures of places that are like full up. That's always a good
sign. Yeah. Well, what year was that? 2016. Yeah, well.
The last good year. But.
Better times. Is this some it's like a BLT but with like crumble bacon?
I could because then you're not pulling off the bacon
yeah.
when you're like
yeah.
Chopped bacon.
Ooh, here we go. Look at all these different yeah, that's a lot of they got the sun chips. They got that chili cheese Fritos.
Classic, yeah.
And shout out, they have a whole fucking line of sour cream and cheddar ruffles. Thank you. Thank you.
And they got the Miss Vickies at the end. Which
yeah, you're absolutely right. That's a good way to do a BLT.
I like it. Yeah, you're not pulling off the whole sandwich.
This is like some sort of hero thing, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. I can't tell what meat it is.
It's hero meat.
What is this, a tuna?
Yeah, it looks like a tuna that they might have undertopped a bit, but
is that fucking pumpernickel?
Oh no! shit! What's going on? What is this? Is this ham?
All of their meat is kind of torn up. I
can't get over all this sad looking bread, dude.
Yeah, this bread doesn't look as good as the other picture, dude. Didn't see it. Is this a chili dog? Let's go.
I wish the cheese was a little melted, but that just can't be too rude.
But then again,
I like it when it's a little textured still.
The hot dog bun bread looks good though. Like that looks like for a hot dog bun, that's good bread.
Well, it's no sweet peas.
And just straight up served in foil. Is this a broccoli and cheddar soup?
Yeah.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, and the bread here, I mean, also again, it's shitty camera work again too. It's not like it's hard to tell.
A little side salad. I've seen worse.
It's okay.
Now that's a decent looking salad. You got the mushrooms, very nice looking croutons, good shredded meat, ham. Well, no, it's turkey, I think. Well, I think it's ham and turkey, actually. Yeah, ham and the turkey.
It's ham and turkey for sure.
That looks all right. Pour some ranch over that. French dip with some, what is this called?
Is that potato salad?
Potato salad. Oh, that looks really good. That bread actually looks decent too.
It's like different types of bread that the other stuff is just basic white.
Look, it's a croissant.
Is it like filled with cum?
It's filled with like
have you seen cum before?
It's like a.
I don't know about yours, but I prefer to produce mine chunky. So.
It's like some sort of like cream chicken stuff, I think.
Yeah, it's like a chicken salad.
That's
what it is. That's kind of
a sad looking bread, and it's the end of it. Ham and Swiss hoagie with tomato, pepper, and pickle. Yeah, I mean that was. I mean, I would go here over Subway any day.
Oh, for sure. But I would go anywhere over Subway.
Let me see if. And most importantly, check out the menu. I've been skipping menus on a couple. Oh, no prices.
That is a pretty extensive.
That's
menu
a big
for a
old menu,
shop.
But no prices, and that makes me nervous.
That chopper sandwich sounds pretty good as far as
subs and such. Since 1983, let's go. Daily specials and free Wi-Fi.
It's as old as you are.
By 10 years?
No, that's the year you were born.
Capri was born in 1983.
Check out those sweet peas.
All right, we'll check out Sweet Peas here in a little bit. Here's prices. Half a combo for a half is 7. A combo for a large, an 8-inch, is 8. And a combo for a super, which is a foot long essentially, is $10. That's a little bit more expensive. Well, a good bit more expensive than Subway, but.
Well, sure, but you're also getting.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
If you get one of their big loaded sandwiches here for $10, you're getting the amount of food equivalent to $2 $5.
Oh, sorry. And that's a combo. For just a sandwich, it's $8, which.
That's not that bad.
That's not that bad. And this was February 2020 though.
Now, interesting, you'll note that they actually give a range on the length for the sizes. They're not being super precise there.
Well,
they're saying 11 inches to 12 inches.
Legally, I think they have to. So yeah, they also have pita bread. They have a wrap. They have hot dog. They have croissant. So yeah.
I think this place would be good. I think it looks decent.
A beefy boy's meat here win.
Yeah.
I'd be down.
This
solid sandwich option.
This is your specialties. Again, no prices. That kind of skews me out, but whatever.
Are they all the same price? That's what I'm
thinking. Yeah, they got the chicken Kaiser. They got the hot dog. Yeah, I mean, this place. Yeah. Okay, even if they're all the same price, I want to know what that price is. You know what I'm saying?
Well, we could infer from, when's that menu from? Is that 2020?
What do you mean? It's $10.50 for a super. It's $8.25 for a large.
Right, but I don't know. Does that include the specialties too, though?
Because
this is oh, okay. All right. Well, I don't know about that.
Yeah,
but
well, that makes sense. Now you see what happened to the menu.
That's the rough ballpark.
We'll agree to disagree on that one. All right.
Okay.
Well, no, we all can't be right, Taylor. What? I'm sorry.
Well, that's in a different area, perhaps. You've been in this area.
All right, let's go.
North about 20 minutes. You might find a little place called Sweet Peas.
Sweet Peas. Yeah, I heard a lot of good things about Sweet Peas.
Do we want to go to Sweet Peas, boys?
Maybe let's just get Sweet Peas out of the
fucking way. Let's just get Sweet Peas out of the way so he'll shut the fuck up.
Is it Knoxville?
Yeah.
Now, what's your attachment to this place, Capri? Let's get some backstory.
Well, first off, it's just Sweet Pea, so you've been saying it fucking wrong the entire time.
No, it's Sweet Peas, like not P-E-A, just P-apostrophe-S. Are you
there is a Sweet Pea. Oh, here we go.
Yeah, Sweet Pea.
I'm sure Capri loves Sweet Pea.
Oh, there's actually two. We'll do the downtown one. We'll do the downtown one.
Yeah.
You know what? I like that I've been brushing you off the entire time about this, but I think this is actually a place that I have, like, bookmarked.
Sweet Peas is legit.
Okay, all right, fine. All right, Sweet Peas, Downtown Dive, 410 West Jackson Avenue. This is Knoxville.
It's just north of Gay Street. Yeah, there's a Gay Street.
Yeah,
there's a Gay Street trolley.
We know. This is looking like a Parmesan dip, is what I feel like that is.
Probably a beer cheese.
Could be. Ooh, okay. Okay, so let's break this down. First off, the beans kind of look a little mushy. I'm not really a beans, black eyed bean, you know what I mean.
Pinto. Yeah.
The mac and cheese, though, Pinto. First off, I don't think that's like, they're not baked. That's like something on them, I think. Like,
yeah.
That's barbecue sauce.
That looks like a baked layer to me.
No. I thought that at first, but then I noticed like down here, you can tell like it shines a little bit. They put like barbecue sauce on it. The mashed potatoes, though,
interesting.
I'm seeing the skins. I'm seeing the chives. Yeah.
Good quality.
Now, looking at the meat in the back, I just got to point out how much those ribs resemble pumpernickel bread.
Fuck.
Okay.
Off.
Yeah. Thank you.
Shut the fuck up. I'll kill you. Okay. We got greens. This mac and cheese looks okay. It looks very creamy, and
looks very cheesy, which I'm a fan of.
That makes, yeah. Very seasoned meat on that one. American lager, the drinker. Sad, hate saying.
Oh, Highwire is actually pretty decent.
No, it's not. There's no such thing as a decent beer.
Meat looks solid. Look
at this.
Brisket?
Damn. Look at this coleslaw.
Yeah, no, nice portion.
Yeah, that's some not. Yeah, that is actually really nice. Ooh, hello.
Those are saucy boys.
Those are some saucy boys.
All right.
Yeah, I'm on board.
That meat looks moist.
I'm on board with this mac and cheese.
Yeah, this is probably the first good barbecue place we had all stream.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, nice little al fresco area. Okay.
Wow.
Nice view of the traffic cones. Love to see.
Dude, Sweet Peas is all right.
What is?
You.
Is this like a banana thing or something?
Oh, banana pudding maybe.
Yeah. This is vegetarian.
It's like a barbecue wrap.
Hold on a second. Now
that's weird.
That looks okay. Sweet peas. I gotta go to different sauces. Vinegar based sauce.
I do like vinegar based sauces, I gotta say.
Yeah, North Carolina.
Vinegar's usually almost always used to hide fucking shitty ingredients.
Yeah.
All
right,
yeah, those are some seasoned wings.
Yeah, I mean, that's
a
season for you. Come here.
All right, let's check the prices here. We got I see. Okay, now I got it. All right, so $12 for a plate, two sides. A full rack of ribs is $26. That's a little expensive, boys.
that's not beyond the pale for
a rack of ribs. That's just what you pay.
Not around here. But then again, I live in the sticks, so that's whatever. $10 for a smoked turkey club? I don't know about that one. So yeah, this place is a little expensive.
Now let's the thing is though, this looks like a relatively high end barbecue spot, and it's in a downtown area. It's gonna be a little bit.
So with that in mind, it's not that bad. Okay, so we looked at Sweet Peas. Fuck you. We're going back to Maryville. Where's Maryville? I lost Maryville. Gentlemen, I lost Maryville.
To the bottom left.
Gentlemen, I lost Maryville. There it is. Found it. Don't worry, we found it.
How about the airport? What's the airport got?
Oh, actually, Aroma Cafe Cuban food and sandwiches. Do we want to go ethnic again? Or?
I've looked at that place before. It's good. You should take a look.
Okay.
I remember thinking that place looked decent.
Okay. Yeah.
Cuban food.
Imagine the smells.
Definitely has the look.
Cubano. Bad picture. Fucking sure. 2006 ass picture, but yeah. It looks good.
Again? Well, these are all promotional images, so it's just probably some shit they pulled from their website or something. Oh, yeah. Look at this. This thing is tucked in, like, the back 40 of something. Okay, here we go. All right, so here's a menu.
Yeah, this looks good.
2022, those are pretty much current prices.
I mean, this was this month, yeah.
$12 right. For, yeah, sandwich, rice and beans, and a fountain drink.
Mm-hmm. Dude, that's not bad. That's not bad at all.
God, yeah. I love Cuban sandwiches, too, man. That's not bad. Shit.
Hello.
Oh, God, that looks good.
Hello.
Number two, if you go back to Sloppy Jose, that looks pretty good.
Yeah,
that does actually good, yeah.
Potato sticks, mayo, mustard.
Yeah, head in there and be like, let me get that Sloppy Jose real quick.
$9 sloppy? Oh,
God. So what is this what sandwich is this supposed to be? This looks good.
I can't tell.
This is some kind of cheesesteak with green onions.
It looks good, though. It looks good.
Well, let's go back to the menu and see what we can see.
Probably their cheesesteak, yeah.
I guess that's their steak one. Yeah, I guess that's just their version of the steak.
As far as like weird inauthentic cheesesteaks go, this looks pretty good.
I did it. That's just a terrible picture.
Next.
Oh, good. Hello. What the fuck?
Fucking montage.
Collage of shit. God, who's taking these pictures? Hold on, no. Ben saw that.
What's going on with BJ's?
Yeah.
Again, looks decent. It's like a jerky something. Turkey Cuban, maybe? Because it's got the ham, too.
Yeah. And was that red beans and rice? Is that Cuban?
No. It almost looks like a jambalaya, though. It looks
It does, actually. That's weird. Oh, yeah, I think a lot of this... what are those, plantains?
Plantains?
Yeah.
Those look tasty, yeah.
I love me some fried plantains. That shit's good.
Yeah. This is the ground beef thing, huh?
That's the croquette.
Oh, yeah, I bet that's good. Okay. Not sure how we feel about this,
but yeah.
Is she the 99 cent, the $99 sloppy?
You ask her and she gives you a different sloppy, Jose.
That looks pretty decent as far as beans, rice, and meat goes.
Yeah, that's just some black beans poured out. Yeah.
Picture.
Who took these pictures? And they need to be shot.
This whole area, there's like a really open market here for somebody to come in and like do much better fucking photo marketing.
Yeah.
You think the South gives a fucking shit about your pictures, prude?
Look, it influences my this is more
of the same. Yeah, I mean, that looks okay.
Nonetheless, the food looks great. The pictures suck, but I think the food would be good.
You're right. We've been up here, too. Let's go back in south a little bit, down into this area. We got some Thai cuisine. How y'all feel about Thai cuisine?
Oh, yeah. We haven't done much Asian. Let's check some Thai.
I don't eat Thai unless it's really good.
Why is that? Because
we can just make it at home.
Yeah, okay, well, that's fair.
That's decent. Yeah,
it looks all right, yeah. Yeah. Shrimp look a little overcooked.
I wouldn't go here and order fucking mussels or whatever, but
was it? Whoa. Yeah, I don't know about that. Yeah.
No.
I'm not really feeling this place.
I'm just not a big like Southeast Asian.
Let's see if we can find it. Well, let's see if we can find a Chinese. Yeah,
this is Chinese for sure. Well, there's Panda Express.
Yeah, I saw that. I was like, no, I'm not doing that. Let's see.
There's a Chinese place down towards the south.
I know exactly the one you're talking about. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's actually
Osaka Japanese Hibachi Grill. That's not Chinese, but that's Asian.
What's TC's? I just noticed this TC's Grill. Oh, hello. This actually looks really good. Detour, but we'll get back to the Chinese in a second.
Sure.
This looks another like boomer tourist trap place, but. They just straight up burned that.
Well, that bacon. The other bacon looks good though. I don't know what happened to the third one.
Oh yeah, look, boomer, 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 boomer.
Yeah, turn your monitor on.
You're literally older than I am. That joke doesn't work. Decent looking fries.
Yeah, this place looks all right actually.
This looks all right.
I like the texture on the tendies.
Now that's a nice breakfast plate right there.
Yeah.
I'd have to have the scrambled done a little bit more, but the potatoes
scrambled, those are over easy.
You know what I mean. I would have to have them scrambled is what
piece
I'm saying.
Shit, fuck you.
Fuck you.
The red yolks.
No, fuck you. Oh, hello.
Oh,
Let's go. Let's go.
Is that a chicken fried steak?
That is a chicken fried steak, yes. Oh, my God.
That is the best right there.
With that's brown good. And white gravy.
The brown gravy looks a little thick, though. It needs a little bit of water. It's a little congealed.
Oh, here we go.
Just use the white gravy on the potatoes, too.
That's banana pie for $4. Yeah. I don't know what kind of serving size that is, but... what is this? Egg and bacon with... Is that fried tomatoes?
Oh, yeah, is that?
Yeah.
Looks like it.
Looks like a hush puppy, almost.
Yeah, like a flat hush puppy.
It has the shape of
it. It's a fried tomato.
Now, that's not the worst looking mac and cheese I've ever seen.
Interesting little sliders.
Yeah, little sliders.
The buns on those look a little sad, but...
They look a little sad, but they just look sad. BLT.
Now, this looks promo, but this looks like a really nice BLT.
This is from Khaki Hurley.
Okay, this is a good picture.
Just
this
someone who actually knows how to take good pictures.
Yeah.
Oh.
That looks like a decent salad if you're going to order a fucking salad at a place like this.
I need my chicken pre-cut.
Sure, I'd rather that.
Beans and chili. No, mm-mm. Yeah,
little
kids.
Beans are fine if it's entree. Ooh, those look decent.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it almost looks like they needed to be double dipped.
Yeah. That was like rushed almost.
Rookie mistake. Double dip.
This is like an old gas station. You love to see that.
Checkers, that.
All right. Yeah. So this Empire Garden. I think this is the one we've looked at before, Prune.
Yeah. I mean, certainly it's one of them. I think
it's very like this is just very basic. See, and I'm gonna
standard Chinese. Yeah, you can go anywhere in a country.
Yeah. This isn't even a buffet. This isn't now. Nah, fuck. Oh,
but
show me.
I would eat it, but
show me a buffet. Here is this Chinese
Peking kitchen.
Yeah, buffet. Here we go. All right. Now this is what I'm looking for.
I think we saw this one, and it was like kind of like okay, it has lower reviews, but buffets always do.
Yeah.
So
it doesn't look good. No.
That person fucking soaked the rice in the sweet and sour sauce, which is strange.
What the? What are we doing here? Are they complaining about like?
The fucking window fixture's dirty.
No, I'm gonna barf.
This looks like typical.
This is low test. Next,
Jack saying untapped market boys. I think I know what kind of restaurant we need to spin up. I'm excited to hear this. This place looks dirty. Fuck this place.
Well, it's Chinese.
Here we go. Asian buffet and grill got a 3.9 rating for 1300.
This is Ming Tree over here. A couple of places down the line. Fucking Dollar Tree for Mings. this looks better.
This looks better. I'm gonna go ahead and say I don't like round lo mein noodles.
Ooh, as opposed to what?
Flat.
I've always had them round. But...
That's the thing. I think. Oh God, fuck that.
That looks solid. Crab legs. The sushi doesn't look terrible.
Actually say this lo mein for round noodles looks okay. I'm just used to flat because that's what our place has.
I mean, frankly, I'm not going there for the lo mein anyways. I'm going there to load up on fucking fried meats.
No, I load up.
I'm not going there for cheap carbs. I'm getting the maximum value out of it.
I got some soups. I mean, this place is okay. I've seen worse.
That sushi looks all right for buffet sushi, I think.
I've seen much worse. The meat looks decent here. I mean, yeah, this is just a real bog standard kind of place. Yeah,
I mean, you can only ask so much from a fucking buffet, right?
Like,
I know a place you should check out.
If you say sweet peas, I'm banning you from Discord.
Have we checked that China House yet?
Frank and Lola's in Bartlesville, Oklahoma, the middle of nowhere.
That's not even anywhere near me. No, okay, I'm not doing this with you.
See this 4.4 China House?
That's
really
I've ever had in my life.
What China House?
There 4.4. Yeah, okay. That might be a worthy.
Is this this looks like this is an order place? But...
Nope.
Simple menu doesn't not bad price.
I've looked at this before. I've looked at this before because it's right next to an advanced printing shipping, which I thought was funny.
It looks all right. Very, very old interior.
Yeah, this is definitely a you come in, you order, you leave kind of place.
You get a hand job and then you leave.
Well, that's my kind of place.
Well, it's not your mom's not there.
What?
This is some dude's house.
House.
Holy shit, are we gang stalking someone now? What the fuck? That was weird. Yeah.
I'll be right back.
I don't feel this place. All right. Texas Roadhouse. That's definitely just.
Been to 1,000.
Yeah. Let's see if there's any more.
Lola's.
Oh, here. What is Classic Twist? It's It's just a fucking empty field. Okay.
What a twist.
Thanks. That is a classic twist. There's nothing fucking there. I'm not checking that place out. There's probably nothing fucking there. Green Time. There's actually two places here, and they're both like a tavern, though. That tells me that they might like have food, but no, according to no.
Look at Turkey Creek. That's the nice area of Knoxville.
We're not talking about Knoxville. We're talking about Maryville.
Yes, you are. You're like 20 minutes outside of Knoxville.
No, it's completely different cultures. It's fuck not. Off. Fuck you. I'm not playing.
Anyone
here.
Who lived here would be like, "Oh yeah, I'm right outside of Knoxville."
I would take pride in living in Maryville. That shows me how little you know about Tennessee, you Yankee.
You will regret your words and deeds.
Yeah, I've actually been to Tennessee. That's the difference.
Now, what's interesting about this place is those are like the exact same chairs with that other Mexican restaurant.
Well, they got them from the same Mexican supplier.
That's just going to be the same shit. Oh my God, Applebee's?
Wow, what a small indie restaurant.
Yeah. Ooh, Hot Stone Pizza in the middle.
I saw there was a Sonic. That's our sponsor.
Oh, hello. Okay. This actually looks... This might be promising. This might be the first good pizza place. Ooh.
That looks okay. They got the little color on the crust.
Yeah. This doesn't look like frozen shit, at least.
Scoops and slices? What was that? Is that a different location?
No, I think they just do ice cream as well.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Bluebell, by the way. Shout out. Fun fact, this stream is sponsored by Bluebell.
Okay.
This is like a calzone?
I don't know what kind of... fillings are going there.
No, that's
a very simple salad.
Is that Kaiser dressing or is that like a thousand?
That's a vinaigrette.
Yeah, that's okay.
No, this place looks like shit. Ooh.
No, this is okay. This is okay. Was that a cannoli?
Definitely need more pictures of the fucking pizza. Not the stand.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that pizza looks decent back there in the back.
What the heck?
Those onion rings almost burnt. Yeah. I do appreciate how fancy their signage is, though.
It's quite cheesy.
Yeah, these calzones look good, though. I'm gonna say that.
No, they don't.
We're done, though.
Good. Of course, all the fucking Yankees are in here complaining about the pizza.
What in tarnation?
Yeah, complain about California. What shitty fucking food?
What in tarnation is this?
This looks good. Yeah, it looks great.
It looks like a classic from that place. The fucking cum pie.
Okay, all right, here's another pizza place. Will we finally find a good pizza place? No, this place has shit reviews.
What you want to look for in good pepperoni pie is it got to be those pepperoni cups, the little cups that curl up when
weirdly cooking. Enough, this place has one photo and it actually looks like the best place. That's disappointing. We already checked Metro. That was a place that sucked, even though it has really good ratings.
Olive Garden, look, maybe you'll find good pizza there.
Oh, hey, I wonder if these guys have good pizza. I actually...
Probably is the best
I actually like Papa John's, it's not bad.
It's actually funny that they're right next to the Pizza Hut, too. They're like right across the
street. Bahia Bowls? Oh, that sounds like a chain.
That's like fucking Fruit Bowls.
They made like, a whole...
That's Californian bullshit.
They made a whole... What's Midland?
It's Peepaw reading the fucking
Peepaw.
To read the paper.
Oh, good old Peepaw. Oh, is this like a breakfast place?
Diner. Looks like a diner.
Ooh, that looks all right.
Places to read the paper for sure.
Oh, look at that egg! Damn. Oh, and that's not a terrible. It's a frozen hamburger. But it's not the worst frozen looking hamburger. You got some
fries. Fries look sad though.
Yeah,
that's okra. That's fried okra.
I know it's okra. I've seen bigger. Yeah, this is just like a real standard like diner type place. I like that.
Just like sitting at
Midland restaurant, just like sitting at grandma's table. New guy in chat, Teaches of Peaches. That last place was a hard pass. Welcome, Teaches of Peaches. You're a brand new guy that I've never seen before in my life.
Is that Peaches?
Yeah, it's Peaches. I'm doing a bit.
What's up,
Peach? Hey, Peaches. That last place was a hard pass. Oh, wow. Now, see, what's going to be interesting is we now have... So we have three Yankees in chat are here. And then we've got me and Peaches here, actual true blue blood... Southerners
and me,
right? Yeah, I said there are three Yankees.
And you,
three Yankees, Capri, Mez, and Prude. Yankees. Oh, hello.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, I'm a...
I'm sorry, hold on. Let's list the places you've lived. All right, like fucking Maine, the islands, apparently.
Yeah, Maine.
Yeah, the moon.
No, you want a list?
The moon, Washington, D.C., Moscow.
No, I haven't lived on the moon.
Mongolia.
Prague. Mongolia.
Mongolia.
Beijing. Bangkok. Cambodia. So, yeah, I mean, you've lived in way more Yankee places than you have American, so... Or Southern. Which is also
in,
you know,
Maine.
Okay,
I
Maine.
Lived in Boston.
Right. So Yankee. So yeah. So maybe we don't. Maybe what?
I'm born in Tampa.
The fuck? The my brother in Christ. Where's the bond?
Lived in Virginia, North
Yankee,
Carolina,
Yankee,
and Georgia.
Yankee.
Not what?
Yep. All those were Yankee states.
So Georgia's a Yankee state.
Yes. Ever since they beat Alabama in the national championship, they betrayed the South. We're not even talking about the food anymore. This place looks
Bro,
okay.
I lived in Mobile.
My condolences.
The fact that you didn't call it Mobile. Yeah.
No, I lived in Mobile. So is that a Yankee state too?
Cheddar's Scratch Kitchen. What the fuck?
That last plate was a hospital plate a little bit. Virginia,
so what's
Yankee.
Cheddar's place?
Yes. Cheddar's, that's a chain.
Oh, it is? Okay, I've never heard of that.
Cheddar's, no, that's definitely a chain.
Well,
yeah. Cheddar's is not that.
It's another regional, I think, though.
It's like a Jason's Deli.
I'll tell you what, McAllister's is a chain, but it's also very regional.
Yeah, it's good.
And I don't think a lot of people know about McAllister's.
They actually have that where I live in Texas.
I think it goes all the way out to Texas. I think it's just a southern thing.
Where'd you live in Texas?
Like Houston area. Like outskirts of Houston. Like,
did you go there to have sex with a WoW chick?
He did, yeah.
For like a whole year.
Oh, hey, hold on.
It's pretty
donut
cool.
Donut place.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Palace. Actually.
First off, this place is 1,000 years old. So
it looks good already, though.
Marking its honor. By the way, remember the number one rule of like little small restaurants, the worse it looks on the outside, the better it is on the inside.
Right.
Yeah. Ooh, okay.
Those all look pretty good.
Yeah.
Solid.
They're thick boys too. Thick boys. Even this kid's excited about it. He's like, hey, look at this. Fuck that kid, though.
Yeah.
But he's a... I don't know. what he's going to accuse him. What the fuck? That's like a...
Let's look at the... like a bear claw with strawberry or something.
That's not a donut.
That's not a donut either.
That's a twist.
Yeah. Hello. Look at the size of that boy.
I'm glad the spoon is there for
spoon,
reference.
Yeah, spoon for reference. Ooh. Hey, it's just like your mom's. Yep. One of us had to be the first one to do it, so I thought, why not?
Sure.
Not seeing a lot of.
They got the cake style, the old school there on the.
Yeah, I really appreciate that you can like see the like little subtle grill marks, not grill marks, but like, you know what I mean, like where they put it on the thing to let the glaze. Yeah, let the glaze run off.
You know, it's a real donut.
Yeah.
That sprinkling job.
Well, it's not the sprinkling job I'm so concerned with,
yeah,
but
just fuck the, you know, the bottom right.
Yeah, that's a old fashioned style, right? So it's not. I don't think that one's a yeast donut.
I'm just not a huge fan of this.
Sure.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just gonna walk in there and let me get an asshole.
What is going on with the fucking
monitor on?
The fake bokeh in this image is fucked.
Yeah, I hate that. I mean, we're not breaking new ground here with donuts. I mean, if you want to break new ground with donuts, there's a place called the Fryer, the something Fryer over in Gatlinburg. That's the place.
Whatever,
you go.
Dude. What do you want? You want like pistachio?
The bird in the book.
Donuts?
This place sounds pretentious as fuck.
You want deconstructed avocado toast donuts?
No, I'm not you.
This looks like a lot of Californian like gastropubs. Let's
yeah. What am I looking at here?
It's like a burrito with like a chicken fillet in it.
Yeah, we got a cutlet. Oh,
wait, we got a guy
okay.
doing magician
He's doing
shit?
Magic. Bro.
What's on Peach's link here? Doe's Eat Place in Greenville, Mississippi. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at this. Look at this place. It's got bars on the fucking window. The fade. Hold on. I don't know why I click on.
The food is gonna be good.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's a good looking piece of
meat. Are you kidding me? Get the fuck out of here. Oh.
What?
Yeah, look, this place looks like shit. You got just people hanging out outside.
You got hard pipe hitting brothers out there.
Yeah, oh my god. Look at this place. This place looks like shit. But I bet. What is that?
What?
I don't know what that is. Family owned since 1941 in the same. Oh my god! Look at those fries.
Some nice juice.
What? Look, it's got a bunch.
Family owned. That's a cornerstone of the community.
Just a bunch of shit on the walls that you're never gonna.
It's definitely a money laundering place, and so
no. We should all eat there. Oh my god!
That looks so much better than the last.
Peach said, "Like fuck." Peach says, "Tamales, you nerd. You're a nerd."
That shit looks good.
Oh, they got the beer. Here's prices. Tamales, 14 for a dozen. That's not terrible. Homemade chili, a pint, $10. A salad for $6. Shrimp, a whole order of 12 shrimp for $27. That's.
I like how all the meat prices are crossed out and they just wrote it in. You know, in Biden's America, as meat price went.
Well, that's expensive for a steak, but
a fucking $54 for a ribeye.
Is that not a lot?
What?
I don't know. Answer my question.
There, man.
That's a lot.
Okay. All right. That's what I thought. Okay.
Well, I mean, especially from a place that's... like, but I will say the ribeyes looked good.
Yeah, they're very thick. I mean, it says 10 ounces, but I think you're getting a little bit more. Oh, that's someone having their 32nd birthday. It'd be nice to know what that's like in 7 years. Yeah, the salads are weak, but I tell you what, these steaks, though, look really good.
You're using that salad as a palate cleanser, though. Oh, yeah, you're not chunking down on that.
Yeah, I already hate this place. Like, I'm not deep in.
Yeah, no, I'm not gonna be honest. I'm not going here because I can make a ribeye a lot cheaper.
I don't care. I don't care.
I can ribeye for $30.
The bird in the book. I should have known that sounded pronounced. Amici? Hmm. It's an Italian place, but What the fuck?
Bro.
I don't know. This isn't the worst thing I've ever seen. They're trying to go for some pretentious plating. What? No. We're done. I'm pulling out. Unlike your father's, I'm pulling out. Culver's, I think that's a chain. Smokey's Pizza. Surely that's not a chain. But that's a stock photo, so that's got me worried. Oh, we already looked at okay, this is the second location of Smoke. Yeah, okay, no wonder that sounded familiar. So there's one on that side of town, and then there's another. There's got to be a good pizza place in Maryville, Tennessee, surely. Pizza.
I wouldn't bet on it.
I would. Okay, Domino's, chain.
Bella pizza is hard to find.
Hold on. Bella Roma pizza. Now this, we might be onto something here.
No, it's gonna be shit. It's gonna be Italian style pizza, which is garbage.
I don't know why clicking on those won't work. That's so annoying. That's okay looking. Well, first off, the contrast is way too like high on this. That's the problem. What is it? Fresh homemade cabbage? I don't know about that.
I told you, dude.
Jack saying another untapped market. Jack, you didn't tell us what the first untapped market was. You can't tell us the new one and not tell us what the other one wasn't. That looks okay. That looks okay.
No. Mm-mm.
Oh, that's a stock
told
image.
You. I told
that's stock
you.
Stock image. God, that's so stock image. Like, no meat looks like that. I mean... Fuck.
Looks like trash, kid.
Turn your monitor on. How do I get back to fucking... Can't. I think I just have to search pizza again. Oh, Little Caesars. Jaboni's Pizzeria? Maybe? Oh. Oh, God. They have, like, the pretentious, like, Naples style or whatever. Yeah. Mm-mm.
What?
Yeah. Well. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not confident that you're gonna find a really good pizza place. And I mean, that's okay. I mean, I've seen worse.
Yeah, that's all right.
If you look at the crust, though, that looks like a really good, like, flaky crust. Oh, Chinese buffet. Yeah, there's like, yeah. So what I'm saying is, like, there's no really good, like, Chinese buffet here, like a really good one. And yeah, there's no like really good pizza. Like, pizza parlor. I don't want an Italian place, right? I want a pizza parlor.
Well, what do the fuck Italians have to do with pizza? They make garbage pizza.
Yeah. Yeah, we just saw.
I don't want Italian style pizza.
All right, let's see if we can have a Metro. Did we look at Metro? Yeah, we looked at Metro. It sucked. Marco's, Bellaroma, Smokies, Papa John's, Jabroni's. No, I keep saying, you know what? Fucking it's Jabroni's. Jabroni's. Blaze Pizza. Mm.
That's the chain.
Oh, it is? Okay. Domino's.
It's like a build your own pizza chain.
Mr. Gotti's. That also sounds like a chain. Papa Murphy's chain. Gondoli. Yeah. Yeah, there's like Papa Dom's. Maybe?
Sounds fetishistic.
We looked at this. Yeah, this was like the one good place that had like good pepperoni. Dogs, I don't think there's a good pizza place here in Maryville.
There's a pretty good pizza place in Wilmington, North Carolina.
Nobody cares about Wilmington. No one cares about that place you just said. Oh, I already looked at that too. Oh yeah, there's no fucking good pizza place. Man, that's depressing. Okay.
I'm sure there's stuff there that's actually fine if you get there and eat it.
Did we look at Los Amigos Mex? Nah, it's just a Tex-Mex. The thing about Mexican places is if you've seen one, you have seen every single one of them. Yeah, and like here's another one.
Well, out there.
A mall. It's in a mall. Yeah, fuck that. Sonic. El Jimador?
El Jimador.
El Jimador. All these places.
Have you seen the Chien Super Tacos there up Sevierville Road?
Where's that?
Go upper right.
Super Taco? Yeah.
Yeah. Have we seen that?
Peaches, we're looking in, this segment's about, we're like looking at Maryville restaurants.
Yeah. So in this segment, we choose a locale. Well, we're doing, choose future locations for us. And we'll do
suggest another place. And you know what? Suggest next week, we'll look at Wilmington or where the fuck you're talking about. Some two horse town.
Check out Tulsa.
Fuck off. I'm not
checking. Check out Bartlesville.
Oh my God. I can't do this with you right now. I mean, yeah, this place looks okay.
It's a little newer than some of the others.
Yeah.
What?
Okay.
Okay, crumbs. That's a Torta. What? That looks good.
Yeah. Man, there's way too many fucking pictures at the end. Oh, hello. We will be closing on Sundays from now on. We hope you know, oh, yeah. Yeah, a lot of these places are... Well, a lot of these people are having to, you know, cut.
Those look decent.
Yeah.
Solid. It's not bad.
Little quesadilla doesn't really show a whole lot.
Yeah, it's you gotta open a quesadilla up to really see.
Looks good. Taco looks good.
Is it that hard to like toast the quesadilla outside a little bit though?
Yeah, it sounds good.
I actually kind of like them when their soles kind of soft a little bit.
Oh,
though.
Bad take.
Yeah, but just a bit. Just bad a little take. Bit of firmness, man. Bad it doesn't take. Have to be like burnt.
Calhoun's.
I don't
that's...
like it flopping on. That's a chain.
Oh yeah. Okay. I just didn't know how like is a region, but if you know of it, then I guess it's not regional. Masala, is that an Indian place?
Yeah, it's gotta be Indian.
Oh shit, okay. Well, yeah,
worth a look.
What do you think Masala is?
We haven't seen an Indian place. That's a stock image.
Hello,
we go. Okay,
hello, my pretty.
Oh, okay.
The logo also look like clip art, but yeah, whatever.
Yeah, well, whatever.
That's samosa chat, you know.
I don't know if these prices are any good or not. Okay, well, I mean, this looks like a real like mom and pop kind of place. Like,
in my opinion, Indian restaurants are always kind of overpriced for how easy it is to just make the Indian
stuff. It looks like this is literally they just like brought their like silverware and plates from home and were like, "Fuck it, good enough." Which I mean, very well could have. I mean, I don't know anything about Indian food,
that's tandoori chicken. It looks decent.
It looks all right.
The inside of it looks like shit.
They
used papyrus for their fucking logo.
I think they did.
Yeah, they did. It's papyrus.
Pakistani and Indian.
Okay.
Two enemies united.
Well, look, okay, you don't go to an Indian place to eat inside. You get it to go. That's how you know it's a good place.
Yeah. Okay, fair.
Yep.
It really seems like they have like four dishes, but...
Honestly, Indian food's not one I ever really specifically crave because it's really easy to make yourself.
It's one of those things.
Yeah, that's the second time you said that.
Here's a Japanese place.
Oh, that looks decent, actually.
Yeah, Inaba.
Hey, got... that place from Persona 4?
Yeah, because look at this fake-ass photography. No,
well, it's just bad photos.
That's fine.
These are all professional photos. They're it's not going to look like that when you order there.
These are from random accounts.
Yeah, these are from random-ass people. This is from This is from Crystal Irwin, who's from... I don't know where the fuck she's from, but she's kind of ugly. So
seems like she eats a lot of sushi. I'm
sorry. Oh god.
Oh god. Okay. Well.
White women alert.
Wee. I mean, yeah. I don't really know much about Japanese food.
That's
so.
Some weird looking miso. So that's
Tonkatsu ramen looks decent.
That looks okay.
Very topping heavy, actually, for ramen.
Yeah.
Sushi looks fine. That's a
tonkatsu
Japanese curry. Yeah.
Yeah. That actually looks good.
Tonkatsu.
Oh man, that is
calamari.
Yeah, that's some squid right there. Calamari is fried, right?
No.
Does not necessarily.
Well, calamari rings are fried.
Ah, okay.
If you order them as an appetizer.
Is this some yakisoba?
Looks like
it's too light to be yakisoba. Isn't yakisoba darker because it's buckwheat?
Yeah.
Yakisoba actually is not buckwheat.
No, that's you're thinking of soba noodles, not yakisoba, which is not
yakisoba buckwheat. Has always been not buckwheat in my experience. I had yakisoba in Japan. It was not buckwheat.
Yeah, okay. We make yakisoba regularly in here.
My
wife, who lived in Japan,
here. Good lord! Between the two of you, where have y'all not fucking lived?
She lived in Japan and South Korea.
About here, here's another Japanese place, literally across the street. So,
is this like Maryville's Japan Town, the little Japanese district?
Well, you know, they do have like that Japanese school. So.
It's just a classic community college.
Well, no, gross. It's I don't.
Why would you spend your time?
This isn't Japanese. This is like Chinese.
Yeah. I like this style of fake Japanese food.
Yeah.
Fake Japanese. Wait, really
God,
Chinese.
This looks like Jesus. This looks like something I get from Kroger and like pour hot water in. What is this art?
This place looks good.
This is the strangest thing to like simp for of all.
What
the
is?
Stuff
we're getting the steak and chicken C3.
I'm gonna get that B2 real quick though. Yeah. Teriyaki with broccoli. One. Yeah. Oh, nice. The one singular egg roll thing
with a fork.
The fuck?
That chicken looks steamed.
Oh, it's the bag's leaking and they're bitching. Shut the fuck up, Karen.
Well, that's probably because they fucking tipped the container over.
Yeah. Well, it's their fault.
And they probably have really good shrimp sauce.
Yeah, I don't know how I feel about that place.
It looks pretty basic to me, but
it looks great. Here is yet another Japanese place just down the road.
It's hibachi, though, so.
Oh, okay.
They're doing the grill thing.
Oh, okay.
Well, like the what was it? Was that place the one that's the chain that's famous for?
I don't know.
Grill.
Actually, based on pictures, I think this is a chain too.
That place looks like it sucks.
It looks way better than the last one.
No, it doesn't.
Windy City Grill. Oh, hold on. Okay. This place, this might be the place.
Yeah. Yeah, that looks, yeah.
What is that supposed to be?
It's a thick patty melt. It looks
Yeah. That looks all right. Yeah. Back the blue. Big back the blue, guys. Bunch of little patch wall. Nice. Love to see it. Ooh. What are we doing here?
That doesn't look like normal ketchup. That's like some sort of special sauce.
Yeah, almost like barbecue sauce.
That's some thick bacon.
Hello. We got curly fries, boys. Hey, fries.
Yeah, this shit's looking good.
That's the cheese on a cheese steak.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and there we go.
That's
there
chips.
Go. Yeah. A couple of them are a little overcooked, but what the hell we got here? We got a whole memorial. A
memorial for soldiers, I think.
All right, okay.
Triangle flag. And the Holy Bible.
Yeah. All right.
Lemon and salt on a plate. Yeah.
I don't.
It's
what?
A missing man table. Yeah.
Is that fucking French onion soup?
Yes, that is.
Wow, that actually looks. This actually looks. What is that? Potato skins. Yeah, not bad.
Potato skin.
Yeah. Actually looks. Okay.
This is probably the first real good place so far on stream.
Yeah, not bad actually. Okay. I'm here for sure.
Okay. Look at 99 and 100 on their health report. I don't know how I feel about that.
They're bragging. They're bragging.
Nice little flex.
Unironically. We'll go there for the Martyville meetup.
All right.
Yep. This is the place.
Do you say Martyville?
Well, what else are we going to call it?
Yeah, we're going to Martyville.
It's Maryville.
Hey,
maybe we were fucking laughing.
Yeah, we did. Look at that.
I think we saw this one. Yeah,
yeah, we did.
Are there any restaurants in Top of the World, Tennessee nearby?
No, because it's on top of a mountain. So
I was curious. You know,
I mean, there's the closest thing is that, well, the barn, yeah, but you have to go all the way around. Okay. No, there's nothing.
Whoa, see God's office? Go back down there. See that?
God's office.
Religious destination. What
the hell? Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. Okay. I mean, sure. Yeah, why not?
Christ is king, bro.
Can we? I can't say it. All right. I mean, sure.
Welcome to the South.
Why? Why not?
That's pretty sweet. That whole area up there in that region.
Yeah. Yeah. Really so sweet. Like, so what you're looking at is like, take it out real far here. So like, all this is very rural and suburban, all the way up to Oak Ridge and Strawberry Plains. All this is very rural, but the thing is, like, everything south of here, from here to Chattanooga, or, well, Cleveland, really, this is all extremely fucking rural, and then obviously into the mountains is extremely rural as well.
Like, the map does a good job of representing where it gets, like, less dense mm-hmm. with just the colors
but
of the gray.
But it's interesting, like, once you hit, like right here, all right, really say, like, past, after you go over, what lake is this? Oh, I guess it's just Little Tennessee River. Once you go over this from Vonore... Yeah, Vonore, once you go here, it's just urbanization all the way into Knoxville. But literally, once you get like 5 minutes out this way, it's just rural as anything in the South. So this is this whole area.
Even more so. Like, mountain people are proto-Southerners.
Well, this is a big valley right here. This is a big valley right here. This is right here starts the mountains. But yeah, so... And there's some good places up here in these mountains, too. I mean, we could... Shit, if we wanted to extend the range here, but we're already creeping up on 3 hours, so
if we get into the mountains, we're gonna step on the toes of a possible like Gatlinburg episode or something. You know,
Jesus, my god,
you coward!
This
the mountains are where you want to go.
This whole area, and this whole area are three episodes in and of themselves. We'll go. You know what? For kicks, we'll go over to Seymour though,
because that's a similar location to Maryville.
Oh, Tennessee. Okay, this place. Like okay, promising. All right, this might be the place. Okay,
that looks decent.
Pleasing thickness, nice. Look at the like the crunchiness on the edge there. Oh, is this a Stromboli?
Stromboli, yeah.
Not bad. Ugly ass boomer waving. Not big on the big T, but it is.
What's the deal with that? What's the deal?
What do you mean? What's
pizza
the
company?
My dude, no, my dude. Do I have to put the hat on? Roll Tide. We don't support the Vols around here.
Well, you know, maybe you should, because maybe they'll be your team one day.
They will
maybe
never be my team over my dead fucking body.
If you're moving there, you have
roll tide. Oh, no, oh my
team,
god, yeah.
Not my president. Here
so,
we go.
So look at like the fucking like just plywood addition that they. Oh yeah, yeah. This is
sad wings.
Sad wings. Sad wings.
But yeah.
I like that. I like the that actually looks okay. They
the slices of sausage rather than
yeah.
That's sad meat lovers. All the meat's the in the fucking this? Middle.
Yeah, looks it like did a, slide a lot. Now that doesn't look as bad. That looks sure, a little bit sure. better.
The sauce definitely could.
Now that's a better distribution of toppings.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. This is okay. So the good pizza places are apparently over in Seymour then.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, this place is pretty okay. Now that looks sad, but I don't know what's going on there. Yeah, now this place, yeah, mm-hmm. All right.
That's all right.
I think I've looked at this one. Mama's Country Kitchen, yes. That sounds familiar. Yeah. Yes, I have looked at this before. This place, first off, look at these serving sizes. That's a healthy plate. I'm not sure what that's supposed to be.
Looks like a breakfast burrito with like,
yeah, food. Yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at the sausage gravy over some biscuits. Yes, sir. Oh, that's a big old cinnamon bun. Oh, my God. What is that?
Cake. Red velvet cake?
Yeah, is it? Like a carrot cake, almost.
I'm not ordering fucking cake at this place, so whatever.
Oh, okay. That's just cut up eggs. Ooh, nice little omelet with the ham cube. Yeah, yes, sir. I don't know about that one.
Next.
Pancakes
and
those are some decent looking. yo, did my dude really just not bring out the super fast like thermometer to eat? What's going on in this picture?
He has to verify that his food's the correct serving time.
I mean, to be fair, that looks pretty decent. I'm not gonna lie, that looks decent. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, hello. Was that like breakfast tacos?
Yep.
Yeah. That's not bad. That's not bad. Yeah,
it's red velvet cake.
You sure? That looks almost carrot cake.
That's red velvet.
That's not carrot cake.
No, all right, whatever. Red. Fuck off. You don't even remember Pecora.
Is that an egg on top of a fucking three paint? What the fuck?
Yes, sir, it is. That's how we do it down here in the dirty, my boy.
I got to get with that.
Sweet crinkle potatoes? That's a first. This is. Is that pork rinds?
Hard to tell.
Yo, is that pork rinds, my dude?
Looks like it.
That's weird. Oh, yeah, now, what? This is like diner food now. Who? What kind of fucking sociopath? No. What kind of fucking psychopath cuts their pancakes up like this?
Getting ready to cut up the victims when he comes back home.
Jesus. Okay, yeah, this is just a nice little diner type one.
It's all right.
No. Ye Olde Steakhouse. Okay, that's got to be good. Oh, yeah, look at this place. I can already tell you this place fucks.
A vintage photo. That looks like a vintage photo almost.
I can already tell you. No, this place fucks. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Got some scrimps.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep. Look, they give you all the toppings to your baked potato all on the
just
side.
Just choose your own adventure kind of situation.
Yeah. Oh, my. This is a classic mountains place. Look at this. The architecture looks like some lodge. Yep. They don't do it like that no more.
Lincoln Logs bullshit.
They don't do it like that no more. Hello. What am I looking at here?
Is that a prime rib? Or?
Yeah, it looks like prime rib.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Was that just two fucking ACs stuck in the... Yeah. Mm-hmm. Decent burg, actually. Decent burg.
Steakhouse style, yeah.
Hello. Yes, sir.
That's a whole lot of meat.
That's a whole lot of... That's beef. That's beef.
Now that is a red belly.
Yeah. Jesus, that's... To quote Jack, diabetes. That's what that is.
Big old scrimps.
Big old scrimps, yeah. Oh, that's oh, look at that. That's nice. Since 1968, food fit for a king? Let's go.
Wow.
Let's go. This is, look, Seymour is the superior place. I've been saying it for years.
Walk in there wearing the Burger King crown.
In the middle of difficulty lies opportunity. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
What is that little cheese snack?
You know what's great about, so I want to bring it back. So like, what's great about this place is this looks like a place, so it's 63. Like back in the day, business deals took place in this place. Like, let me get a big inside shot of it if we can. I saw one.
Right at the start, I think it's this next one.
Yeah. Dude, like look at business deals took place in this place. All right. Men were in here smoking unfiltered cigarettes, having their third steak of the day just before they go off to their second mistress. Big deals happened in this building. All right, this is a place of industry. Men of industry were here. All right, this is
sure.
Yeah,
Burger Boy. I get what you're saying.
This feels like an infringement on the brand Burger Boys.
Yeah, it's a little upsetting because that's like the kind of place that I would open if I was gonna open a spot out there. You know, like I feel like we kind of have to do something about it.
It'll practically burn down summer of 2023 when we all move out there.
Oh yeah, the beefy riots, you mean?
The part that's upsetting is that burger looks okay. So let's see what else they got.
Back in beefy troubles.
I love that. I love the beefy troubles too. Yeah, first off, I love that that old Jamaican place and this place have the exact same architect.
Right.
Which was, oh, yeah.
Eyes in a cup is always a good sign, though.
Yeah. I don't know if this is a chain, though.
Oh, look at that fucking 56% situation there.
With the perm and all, yeah.
He knows Burger Boy.
Look at this kid. He's like, the hell?
Shooter looking at
this dude's looking like, is that a Zoomer perm? What the? Big Dong. The fuck? Oh, here we go. All right. No, this is from 2019, though.
That's still, though, even with the current inflation rate, those prices can't be that bad now.
Yeah. No, that's good.
All right. It's all right.
11.
Where's the food at, though? Okay, that looks good.
I love these kind of this kind of fry right here.
The homemade. Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like the sort of like the Five Guys, like the kind of like
yeah, a little bit. What the fuck?
That's sad. That's chicken. That, two chicken. Yeah. Two chicken tenders.
I thought that was catfish.
The fuck? The fuck? The fuck? What is what? This is like a neural image thing or something. Like yeah, I can't.
Don't go to the burger place for this.
My mind won't concentrate on like any one part of this image. Like it
it's
can't.
It's like a cognito hazard. Yeah. Like a fucking okay. Kill agent.
Oh, we got a little bit of well, not meat in three, but we got grains. Yeah, I tell you what, that mac and cheese don't look bad. I've seen worse.
All right, little topping.
Hey, that's Big Dom right there.
Yeah, this is no way. This is the
that's,
chain. Though.
That's Big Dom. Oh, those are looking almost burned. What is that? Gizzards?
That might be gizzards. I don't think that's okra. Yeah,
that's gizzards. I think.
I'm not going to fucking burger.
I tell you. Oh, hello. Those are okay looking ribs. I tell you what. That's the first gizzards I think I've seen on any Google Maps thing so far, ever. You don't. You go to a lot of.
I really think they should stick to what they know. Though.
Peach is backing me up in chat. Like, hell yeah, that's gizzards. I know gizzards when I see them. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So that's. So he does burgers and also. Okay. So we're practically in Knoxville now. What the fuck.
We're encroaching. I think this is a sign to end it. We don't want to ruin a few further episodes.
Yeah.
We got the Seymour Grill.
Well, we'll look at Seymour Grill, and that's where we'll cut it off. We'll cut it. Check it. If it sucks, we're never doing this again.
And club sandwich that already looks good, actually, to me.
That That's a decent club. Okay, that's not
simple, but looks decent.
Very
like,
simple.
Looks like has a good fry. Onion rings look okay. They're more of the crumbly kind of like breaded type.
Oh, these homemade the cut potatoes like that. That's real big up there.
Tomatoes.
Checkered.
Well, you don't like whoa, checkered? What?
Well, for context, that's what Tennessee does in their end zone.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's another fucking stupid football thing.
But popcorn?
No, I've seen that exact same pattern like up here. That's just like generic food service.
Right, right. But they're doing it specifically for Tennessee though.
Right, right. Uh-huh.
But what is popcorn?
That's an interesting choice. Right. Maybe that's a kid's mini thing. I don't know. It's a dessert of some kind. It looks like a.
That's all right.
What is that?
Oh, hello. What the fuck?
Is that supposed to be lasagna? The fuck?
Yeah, it is.
The side looks, yeah.
That's fucking sad. That looks like fucking ketchup and cheese.
Oh, and is this, I guess for a French dip, I've seen worse.
It's like somewhere between a French dip and like a. Really
you need to take that fork and spread the meat out a little bit.
That's like a shit on a shingle sandwich.
Yeah. What is it? Is this like dumpling? Chicken and dumpling? Yeah, chicken and dumplings.
It looks like dumplings.
I've seen worse. Yeah, I've seen worse. Yeah, we got Graham all down here.
Look
how fucking tight this perm is, though. Jesus Christ, you could bounce a penny off that
look
shit.
Look at that decoration. I will give my all for Tennessee today. That's nice. Ugh. And look, they got a jersey in the background.
Yeah, that's a hockey jersey. Yeah, those are hockey jerseys. I don't know where the fuck those are from. There's not even a hockey team except over in Nashville. Ooh. Now that looks all right. That's like an open face roast beef kind of thing. Yeah.
Happy waitress. Yeah, it's a happy waitress.
Is that what it's called?
I've never heard that.
What
one
is
before,
with the popcorn? Yeah. That's so strange.
That might be their thing though. Like maybe. They're the place that does the popcorn. Like you know?
We do the popcorn. I don't know why that went Italian for that, Italian. But okay.
It's popcorn.
We see it's a great story of an Italian immigrant who came to America with nothing to see more
kernels.
Yeah.
Kernels in his.
Ooh, look at that cut of ham, boys.
That's a big piece of hog.
That's a piece of hog right there. Oh, that's a salad.
The Cobb salad goes. That was pretty decent.
Is that a chicken parm sandwich?
Yeah. That's a bad chicken parm, bro. That's fried chicken with fucking ketchup on it.
Of course, the guy from fucking New Jersey.
I've seen worse. I've seen worse. That's the end of it. Yeah, I know. I've seen worse. Is there? Oh, here's a menu. I've been forgetting to like look at the menus.
Not terrible prices.
When was it? It was 2021. So yeah, this inflation probably hasn't hit this that hard. Yeah, classic. Oh, pot
beef
roast. That's a good one. Yeah, catfish dinner, salmon. That's a strange actually. Have salmon.
I like how they have the country fried chicken and the steak right next to each other. That's nice to have. Options.
Oh, this is what it was. It was spinach lasagna. Yeah.
I think this place would have something for everyone, right? Like it's one of those things. Like you might not like whatever thing that they're serving is, but there's got to be something on that menu.
Oh, they do have just regular
chicken and waffles. I'm surprised there's not a picture of it.
Yeah, I am too, actually.
Because the pictures of the fried chicken they have look
bold claim, the best Reuben in town.
Well, the other Reubens in town
fucking it's on pumpernickel. Fuck off.
Oh.
Oh, these cobblers. Yeah. Okay. So that was just a bread pudding, is what that was.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay. I can't fucking hardly read that. Oh, hello. I mean, yeah, these prices aren't bad, but this is all from like literally last year. Or even before. Yeah, okay. All right, well.
Decent.
Oh, Dot's Restaurant and Catering. No, I'm pulling out. Sorry, we'll pull that out. Because I will keep going. I could do this literally all night. But no, we got to wrap it up, boys. And getting close to that 3-hour mark, dangerously close, some might say. Thanks everybody for coming out tonight. It was a good one. I really appreciate when we do these little like weird segments that end up taking up like. I mean, the news tonight was very slim. Not much happened. Just the Elon thing.
That's Jankowicz. Okay.
Yeah.
I think maybe next beef cast will have a beefy shooting breakdown. Maybe.
Oh, on God.
Yeah, I'm gone. I'll be off.
Okay. You'll have to walk me through that. Yeah. Next week, I will have the stream a little bit set up better because, you know, I had to reformat the app. I really hope that fixed my blue screen issue. If it doesn't, I mean, I'm going to have to, like, RMA my board, my motherboard. So, yeah. Anyway, yeah, thanks everybody for coming out tonight. No special streams this week, I don't think, Prude?
Nothing comes to mind, but of course, we're here.
Hold on. There was talk, not talk, but Blizzard is announcing their mobile game this week.
Oh yeah.
I don't think we're gonna do a live watch for it. Do what?
It's the third.
Well, I mean that's this week. So.
Tuesday. Yeah, I'm saying, yeah. It's Tuesday. Yeah, it's this Tuesday.
Yeah. We're not gonna do a live thing for that because I don't give a shit. It's a mobile game. Who fucking cares? But we'll probably talk about it next Friday. You should definitely come next Friday. You know. We do this every Friday, 9 CST, but CST is not always here, but we're glad, shout out to that though. Very nice having Mez here tonight. Very nice having CST here tonight. I think either
soon we'll have Jack.
Yeah. I think either this week or the next, it might be the next Jack. If you can tell me, we'll have to start having Jack on more often. That's going to be good. I tell you what, I'm very excited for Jack to be on because we've had a great segment in the works since literally December. That we haven't been able to do because of his schedule, where Jack is going to make me drag my ass through some retro video game that he suggests because I infamously don't really like vintage video games. So that'll be a good one. Same time next week. Glad you're all here.
Check the links below if you want to join the Discord.
Let's hit it real quick because we didn't do any. We did zero ad reads today, and that's how you know it's a good show when I did no ad reads. And I didn't even run ad breaks tonight. That's how good this show was. Let's do a quick ad read. I'm seeing here, there's a really fucking strange link here. Beefyboys.win? What? Can you walk me through that, Prune? What's beefyboys.win?
Well, it's interesting because it's both a description of what we're doing here as Beefy Boys, we're winning, but it's also a link that will take you to a website. And that website is our newer Fediverse instance that has replaced beefyboys.club. It's going great. A lot of activity the last couple days. A lot going on. Some good beefs.
There has been some great beefs.
Beefs with the Nuremberg's. Beefs with people from Gav Rejects. Who?
I tell you what. Like, I just want to interject there real quick. The one thing, because I mean, we don't really talk about Fetty drama in here because that would be stupid. But
it's gonna be a major segment.
Yeah, no. But I do want to say I think it's just hilarious because we shit on the Nerms, the post Nurembergs all the time. But there is literally nobody stupider than those Nice Credential guys.
So basically we just made a satirical post and they took it like at face
just
value.
Absolute
and, like, went all in on trying to like
in.
Get us.
And then a couple of them went, oh, all right, haha, you got us. But some dudes just
Some argued for like an hour and then we're like, oh, never mind, I was stupid. And it's like, why'd you spend the 20 seconds to click the link on my profile and see that I'm not the person you think?
And it's just that. And it's like, I don't, without getting into talking about it on Twitch, but like the person that was linked, it was like, I know that's not like a super common person, but then again,
And all the people that we're kind of making fun of there are public figures, though, to some capacity. Mm-hmm. Like they're not. It's not.
But it was the great thing that if you encounter someone who has really strange, like either aversion or lack of knowledge on anime, who's also extremely online, there's a very high percent chance they're fed. So,
right. Yeah. Just in general, though, yeah, it's been fun the last couple of days, so that's great. Mm-hmm. So if you're somebody who's into that sort of stuff, join the instance. We also have a new link, similarly, of wideboys.win, which is now our kind of universal invite for the Discord that we have open to all.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow! Glad I'm not showing my fucking screen right now. That's fine. It's fine. We're not. I'm just gonna go to a different tab for a while. Yeah. No. Wide boys don't win. We set that up this week. It's a lot better, easier way to invite people to the Discord than fucking Discord.gd uppercase NJ3729er. Way easier.
Right. The link below the stream right now will still use just the stream invite link.
Can replace that with win. I haven't updated that either.
Doesn't want to make a difference. Same result either way.
Yeah, but in situations where you can just click a link, it doesn't really matter.
Well, and I like it too because if you ever need to replace the one invite link we provide to people, you can just pack a new link behind the domain, and then it will automatically redirect them. Without having to replace all your links, right?
Yeah. So, but yeah. Yeah, man, we've been having a good time. Sorry, I interrupted your ad read, but go ahead. I don't know. I don't remember where you were.
I got done with BVBoys.win. Oh, okay. I mentioned wideboys.win. What else do we want to talk about?
Oh, the one thing I was going to say is actually, I don't know if you realize this. I'm sure you do, but Sunday is the 1 year anniversary of our entry to FETI, more or less.
Right. No, yeah, I knew it was coming up here.
I got a little promo thing I'm gonna link. It's going to piss some people off, but.
Okay. It'll be fun either way, I'm sure.
Yeah. I mean, you'll agree. You'll read it and go, yeah, no, I agree with that.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So, all right. Again, thanks everybody for coming out tonight. See y'all here 9 Central next week, every Friday, actually. Who knows what we'll be talking about next week? Because it's been crazy shit. It's been a crazy year so far. What did we start? I forgot what we were talking about like at the beginning of the year, but then it was like, there was like Canada shit. There's a war. Yeah,
I feel like that was a recurring bit relatively early for sure.
Yeah. So, all right. See everybody. Do I have it set up to do the right thing? No, I do not. There we go. All right. I didn't update that either. It's fine. Whatever. Fuck it. See everybody later. Keep it beefy, boys.